Today's Auburn broadcast will begin in 8 minutes. Today's Auburn broadcast will begin in 5 minutes. Four minutes till start of broadcast. This broadcast will begin in 3 minutes. Here's your 2 minute time check. Mark. Here comes your 1 minute time check for this Auburn broadcast. Mark. Seconds till broadcast. Mark.
This season, the Gamecocks beat Clemson at the start of the year. That Clemson team leads the ACC. Carolina then went to Kentucky and won it rough. The Wildcats haven't lost since. And today, Auburn tries to add to a four-game losing streak in Columbia. Good afternoon, War Eagle, from the Colonial Life Arena with Brad Law and Jacob Hillman. I'm Andy Bertram. Wednesday night, Auburn traveled to Baton Rouge and emerged the victor for the first time since 2017. Defense carried the night. LSU did record a field goal in the last 6:27 of the game. South Carolina lives and dies by the three. Against Clemson, the Gamecocks nailed 7 from long range. Against Kentucky, Carolina was 11 of 20. And in SEC play, South Carolina is shooting less than 30% from the three-point stripe. Auburn has defended the three ball well of late. Mississippi State was 0 of 18. LSU just 4 of 20 on Wednesday. And South Carolina will test that three-point defense today. The CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off starts now.
Exclusive pregame coverage of the Tigers begins now with the CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off. Coming up, analysis, interviews, and a look around college basketball. At CBNS Bank, we've been family, community, and financially strong since we began in 1906. Visit cbsbank.com. Alongside Hall of Fame coach Sonny Smith, here's the voice of the Tigers, Andy Burcham.
We welcome you to Colonial Life Arena in Columbia, South Carolina. Key SEC battle between your Auburn Tigers and the South Carolina Gamecocks. Along with Brad Law and Jacob Hillman, I'm Andy Burcham. Brad, we saw this Auburn team go Wednesday night to Baton Rouge and just steadily pull away from an LSU ball club. You know, all of a sudden you look up, it's a double-digit lead that Auburn never relinquished in the second half of play. One of the things that Bruce Pearl told his team today at shoot-around is, guys, take a look at the record, but this will not be an easy game for Auburn today.
No, and at any time you run into a team that's capable of making a lot of threes, the three-point shot is a great equalizer in this game. Playing at home tends to lead to better shooting from three-point range, and so that makes this South Carolina team dangerous. Listen, the numbers say they're last in the SEC at field goal percentage, the only team averaging under 40% from the floor. They're also dead last in the league in field goal percentage defense. The numbers would indicate that Auburn outmatches this opponent today, but that three-point shot can be an equalizer.
It certainly can be an equalizer today. Auburn will not have Chris Moore again today. Alan Flanagan will be in the starting lineup. But what about the work that Lior Berman has done coming in and playing the three, sometimes an undersized three for the Tigers, and at times when he is in, he will be an undersized three today against the likes of G.G. Jackson, one of the top freshmen in the country.
Lior's last two games, he's played 28 total minutes, so he's averaging 14 minutes over the last two games. He scored 11 points, and he's grabbed four rebounds in that span, and he's only committed one turnover. He's also playing well defensively.
Right.
A couple of knockaways, and I think he's been beaten one time on a drive to the basket. Otherwise, he's building a wall, as the coaches like to talk about. He's guarding his yard, as the coaches like to say. And so on both ends of the floor, he has taken advantage of the opportunity, and he stepped in the absence of Chris Moore.
Today wraps up the double travel week for the Tigers at LSU on Wednesday. Here against South Carolina today, Auburn will be home against a Texas A&M team that right now is unbeaten in SEC play and leading at Kentucky by two, by the way, at the half. And then we'll go out of the league on the road to West Virginia a week from today to play in the Big 12 SEC Challenge. And from there, Brad, the schedule gets even tougher.
Yeah, it does. This back-to-back road swing, by the way, is the first of three times that happens for the Tigers this year. Later in February, they've got to go to Tennessee and Texas A&M in back-to-back games. Into February, 1st of March, at Kentucky and at Alabama in back-to-back games. And you do, coming up on the back end of this conference schedule, Tennessee twice, Alabama twice. You got to go to A&M twice. You got to go to Vanderbilt. Got to go to Kentucky. So there's no question. If you're supposed to win a game, and they play them on the floor, not on paper. But if you're supposed to win a game, it's why it's so valuable to do that.
The Auburn Tigers put their trust in Auburn AV every home game for the best fan experience, and so should you. Bring the basketball game home when you have Auburn AV design and install your home entertainment system, all with frustration-free controls. Visit auburnav.com. It's already been an interesting day in the Southeastern Conference. To tell you about it, to our Auburn Sports Network studios, and here's Jacob Hillman.
Thank you, Andy, and it is going to be an exciting day throughout the night here in the SEC. Three games in progress or final, and then three games on the schedule later on today. Let's take a look around the league.
From the home of the reigning conference champions to every corner of the SEC, let's go around the most exciting conference in college basketball. This is the Toyota SEC Report. No matter your destination, Toyota goes with you. Toyota. Let's go places.
All right, one game already final today. Number 25, Arkansas, takes down Ole Miss 69-57. A game about to go final. 5.7 seconds remaining. Vanderbilt leads at Georgia 83-82 as Georgia will call a timeout looking to try and win that game. At halftime, Andy mentioned it, Texas A&M leading Kentucky 31-29 at Rupp Arena. And then going on later today, tipping off after Auburn at 3 Central, number 9 Tennessee goes to Baton Rouge to face LSU. At 5 o'clock Central, number 4 Alabama at Mizzou Arena in Columbia, Missouri. And then at 7:30 p.m. Central, the nightcap, Florida and Mississippi State face off in Starkville. There's plenty of top 25 action going on. We'll keep you up to date with that throughout today's game. And what's on the menu is presented by Whataburger. Head over to your hometown Whataburger and taste the tangy, sweet crispiness of the honey barbecue chicken strip sandwich. Three all-white meat chicken strips, two slices of Monterey Jack, and their honey barbecue sauce on Texas toast. The all-time favorite honey barbecue chicken strip sandwich from Whataburger, just like you like it. And what's on the menu today? A 60-second scout of South Carolina with Stephen Pearl and senior guard Zepp Jasper takes center stage for our player profile. Plus, Andy Burcham's exclusive sit-down with Bruce Pearl, Brad Law's keys to the game, your starting lineups, and eventually tip-off. All coming up when the CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off continues in a moment.
CBNS Bank has a long history of stability and a legacy of serving our community's needs for generations. You could say we know a thing or two about tradition. We've been family, community, and financially strong since we began in 1906. Being a team player is part of our culture. That's why at CBNS Bank, we are proud supporters and huge fans of Auburn basketball. Whoa, Regal, hey! Visit cbsbank.com today. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
If you have certain chronic conditions, such as heart disease,
asthma,
diabetes, and you're 19 years of age or older, 52,
36,
42, you may be at increased risk for pneumococcal pneumonia. Ask your doctor or pharmacist about getting vaccinated with Prevnar 20, pneumococcal 20-valent conjugate vaccine, a Pfizer vaccine that can help protect against pneumococcal pneumonia in just one dose. Prevnar 20 is approved for adults to help prevent infections from 20 strains of the bacteria that cause pneumococcal pneumonia. Continued approval may depend on a supportive study. Don't get Prevnar 20 if you've had a severe allergic reaction to the vaccine or its ingredients. Adults with weakened immune systems may have a lower response to the vaccine. The most commonly reported side effect was pain at the injection site. For additional common side effects and full prescribing information, please call 1-855-213-2138 or visit Prevnar20.com.
I'm going to ask my doctor
about getting vaccinated
with Prevnar 20.
Did you know the average piece of produce travels 1,500 miles to reach your plate? When you buy local, you shorten your supply chain and reduce fuel emissions to contribute to a more sustainable world. I'm Ellie Watson, the director of Sweet Grown Alabama, a program designed to help you find locally grown products. Visit sweetgrownalabama.org to search for locally grown produce, meat, honey, and more in your area.
You're listening to Auburn Basketball. Now more of the CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off.
Jacob Hillman here, back with you in our Auburn Sports Network studios to remind you that StubHub is the easiest way to experience every Tigers game. Check the virtual view, score your seats, and get your tickets delivered instantly. StubHub is the official ticketing partner of Auburn Athletics. StubHub, be there. You'll want to use StubHub. As the season goes on, Auburn has the longest home winning streak in the country. And the South Carolina Gamecocks are coached by Lamont Paris, who's in his first season in Columbia. Paris and the Gamecocks notched a couple of marquee wins early in the season, knocking off Kentucky at Rupp Arena to snap the Wildcats' 28-game home winning streak and taking down ACC leader Clemson on the road. South Carolina shot 55% and 39% from three in those contests, both nights being significantly better than the Gamecocks' season average of 31% from three. Stephen Pearl gives us his 60-second scout of South Carolina.
You know, this is a team that, you know, has beaten teams like Clemson at home and won at Rupp in Kentucky, and they've also, you know, gotten blown out at home. So it's really a matter of, you know, which Auburn team wants to show up and play today. So our guys have to lock in and understand that it's not going to be easy. You know, offensively, they really hang their hat on making threes. They averaged, you know, 8 to 9 in wins this year from the three ball. So Michi Johnson, Chico Carter, you know, Chico Carter shoots 50% for three. Michi Johnson made 6 or 7 at Rupp. So got to understand that if they get going offensively, they're really good. You know, Gigi Jackson's a really talented freshman. Then they got some glue guys that play really hard. So biggest thing for us is, you know, obviously we need to guard by our principals, do a great job of, one, keeping them in front, not getting out of rotation, two, contesting three balls, three, rebounding, and then getting out in transition. Then offensively, we just got to take care of the ball, run our stuff, and execute.
Auburn does bring in the nation's third-best three-point defense, allowing its opponents to make just 25.1% of three-point attempts. The 60-second scout is presented by the Raymond J. Harbert College of Business. Accelerate your career with an online MBA from the Harbert College of Business. Learn why they're ranked among the nation's best at harbert.auburn.edu. Well, Stephen Pearl mentioned a couple of South Carolina's best three-point shooters and guards, Michi Johnson and Chico Carter Jr. Someone you're going to see matched up with them throughout today's game is senior guard Zepp Jasper. Known as the Honey Badger, Jasper is one of the SEC's best perimeter defenders and a key to such a strong three-point defense for the Tigers. Andy Burcham sits down with Zepp Jasper for tonight's player profile.
Zepp, what does this region, I mean, Augusta's close, you've played in this state before. What does this region mean to you?
I mean a lot, with South Carolina being one of my second homes, from coming from College of Charleston. It always feels good just to play in South Carolina, to just get that feeling. I had a great game here last year. Hope to have a great one this year. You know, just come out and compete and just try to win this game and, you know, go as hard as we can.
How many folks called you this week and said, hey, I could use a ticket for this game?
Well, I got about 25 people coming, 25 people coming for sure. And hopefully we have a big crowd here, you know, set this arena on fire with nothing but orange. But, you know, it'll be good just to see a lot of Auburn folks in this arena.
Tip-off club is bringing a bus here today. What does it mean to have the orange and blue when you guys go on the road?
It just showed that we had the best fans in the world. You know, it ain't nothing like the Auburn orange and blue. So, you know, every time we step on the court, we see our fans. You know, we just appreciate them. And, you know, that's just love, you know, coming from, you know, 4 hours away, you know, being away from home in Neville Arena. So, you know, it's always good to see Auburn fans in, you know, in another arena.
There will be plenty of witnesses in attendance at Colonial Life Arena today to bring that Auburn jungle atmosphere on the road. Just because the weather's chilly doesn't mean Alabama farmers aren't busy growing high-quality products. Visit sweetgrownalabama.org to make your next Tigers watch party a slam dunk. Find farm-fresh greens, meats, and more at sweetgrownalabama.org. Up next, Andy Burcham's exclusive sit-down with head coach Bruce Pearl, ahead of Auburn and South Carolina from Columbia. This is the Auburn Sports Network.
Live Sports Radio, bringing you inside Neville Arena for all the action of men's and women's basketball game day with no delay. Every dunk, block shot, and steal, plus all the analysis from our Hall of Fame coaches, all with no delay. $25 new or $10 to reprogram the one you already have. Also, use it for every broadcast of home baseball and softball games this spring, all with no delay. With Live Sports Radio, presented by Alpha Insurance.
This is the moment you've been waiting for.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our home.
When you step onto the court and into the spotlight, the moment to show that hard work and long days pay off. Because when that final shot leaves your hands and we leave our seats, that powerful moment connects us all.
Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Power for a better Alabama.
Thinking of advancing your career with a master's degree in business? If so, consider the graduate degree choices at Auburn University's Harbert College of Business. Ranked among the nation's best, we offer full-time and online programs in finance, supply chain management, information systems, accounting, and business administration. Learn more at harbert.auburn.edu.
Did you know the average piece of produce travels 1,500 miles to reach your plate? When you buy local, you shorten your supply chain and reduce fuel emissions to contribute to a more sustainable world. I'm Ellie Watson, the director of Sweet Grown Alabama, a program designed to help you find locally grown products. Visit sweetgrownalabama.org to search for locally grown produce, meat, honey, and more in your area.
Ford presents our exclusive pregame visit with head coach Bruce Pearl. At Auburn, we revere our traditions. Ford has a tradition, too, building trucks that are smart, dependable, and built Ford tough. That's why Ford F-150 is the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. Here's Andy Burcham with Coach Pearl.
The South Carolina team has two really marquee wins against Clemson and on the road at Kentucky. What did they do well in both of those wins?
They shot it well, Andy. You know, in their wins, they're averaging about 8.5 threes made a game. And they got a couple guys that shoot really good percentages in the backcourt. So we got to do a great job of making this team beat us from two and not beat us from three. It just goes to show you that obviously they're capable. They've got one of the top 15 players in next year's draft, and G.G. Jackson, who is a young freshman, matched up against our threes and our fours. And, you know, it's just another road match in the SEC, you know, where we have an opportunity that if we defend and take care of the basketball and continue to do a good job, we got a chance to get this one. But we'll have to play really well. You got to play really well, really hard on the road. You got to play well early.
What has been the key to Auburn's three-point defense in the last three or four ball?
You know, we've always done a good job with ball pressure. That's always been kind of a staple of what we do defensively. I would say guys like, you know, KD Johnson or Sepp Jasper, for example, would exemplify the fact that we do try to press up on the ball in half court, knowing that you know, can make teams running their offense a little bit more difficult. But at the same time, it also can provide driving lanes, and that's where you got to have guys that are in the gaps defensively and in positions to be able to for the opponent to see bodies instead of wood.
LSU, you had the threat of a good three-point shooting team, but also a team that could drive to the basket. What did you do well defensively just a couple nights ago?
Well, that was what we did, you know, obviously, and then got in the gaps and made sure that they saw that where we were. And it, a lot of times it's just still taking away strong hands, you know, just taking away guys that are better driving right than left and paying attention to the scout and having closeouts with a purpose.
Sonny loves to talk about out-of-bounds plays. I mean, and he talks about it a lot. We joke about it a little bit. But you are known for your out-of-bounds plays, not only offense but defense. Where does that come from as far as your coaching philosophy?
We're still running the exact same out-of-basket, out-of-bounds offense and defense that Dr. Tom Davis ran in the late 70s. It's a 1-4 flat on offense, and we've been doing things out of that alignment forever. You know, a lot of people do 1-4 flat, but that's all we've ever done. And then, you know, based on the opponent, their strengths or weaknesses, we'll change things up a little bit. And then as far as the defense is concerned, you know, when a guy picks up his dribble and he can't pass, he can't dribble the ball, and he's out there on the floor, teams will then deny the ball, you know, dead, the dribble's dead, and see if you can turn him over. Well, the same thing when the ball's underneath your own basket. The guy can't dribble it. He can't shoot it. All he can do is pass it. And so we put pressure on him. We deny his entries. And having the ball underneath the basket is a very dangerous place. So it's a place where we try and score, and it's a place where we try and prevent the opponent from scoring.
Do you have Chris Moore available to you today?
We don't. I don't know that if he's available in an emergency, I'll probably ask Trainer Clark if that's the case before the game. But we do not plan on playing Chris tonight.
All right. You've played without him for a couple of games. You won a couple of games. Your rotation is bringing Leor Berman off the bench. He seems to be hot when he comes in. We think about him from an offensive standpoint. Evaluate what he's done for you from a defensive standpoint in spurts.
Well, he's physical, and he's older, and he knows how to play. And so tonight he'll be matched up with G.G. Jackson at times and all the guards. And, you know, the one thing Leor's going to do is going to give you great effort. He's going to be in the right place. He's going to communicate his action. And obviously offensively he's very, you know, he's very, very confident. So, you know, what a luxury it is to have as we talk about developing that depth, developing that bench. And having Leor be a huge part of this program has enabled us to be able to continue to win without Chris.
What do you expect defensively out of South Carolina today?
Well, I mean, I expect them to play with their hair on fire. I mean, this is one they got to get. You know, it's one they can get, right? And so I would expect them to be aggressive and physical. And, you know, we got to keep them off the offensive glass, and we got to make sure we contest those three balls. We do those two things, we got a fighting chance.
Yeah, you told the team earlier today that you think they're a little undervalued as offensive rebounders.
Yeah, they rebound. They're sixth or seventh in the league in offensive rebounding, you know, and they do a good job at all the positions. So the guards have got to make sure that they rebound down and check out their men and limit this team to one shot, especially those effort and energy plays at home can invite a crowd. And when this team makes shots, they guard people. So I think that our defense is going to be able to thing that's going to have to carry us today.
All the best to you today. War Eagle.
War Eagle.
Hey, this is head coach Bruce Pearl. Here at Auburn, we revere our traditions. But it's the tradition of hard work that really speaks to me. It's about improving your game every single day and being the best that you can be. In the truck game, Ford has a tradition too, a relentless commitment to building smarter, tougher, and more dependable trucks. That's why I drive Ford F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. Learn more at buyfordnow.com.
Not all models, trims, or features may be available. Contact your dealer for more information. How are you the ultimate Auburn fan?
Because I got this air horn installed in my throat. Pretty sick, right?
Yes, you look really sick. What doctor would even do this?
Doctor? I did this myself. I mean, I can't swallow whole food, but still.
Wait, what?
Just gotta plow through it. Hey, can I get a couple of soups up here? What about some chamomile tea?
Don't be that guy. Get a fan card. The smart way to be the ultimate Tigers fan. Just go to auburncards.com.
Are you looking to advance your career without putting your life on hold? Consider the flexibility of an online MBA at Auburn University's Harvard College of Business. Ranked among the nation's best by U.S. News & World Report, our 100% online MBA program provides the flexibility you need to pursue a degree while maintaining your personal and professional life. Learn more at harvard.auburn.edu.
Kia of Auburn is happy to connect the Kia brand to the Auburn fans. Our winning lineup has something for everyone at almost any budget. SUVs like the Telluride, Sorento, and Sportage. You prefer a sedan? Check out the Rio, Forte, Soul, or the Sporty Stinger. And don't forget our new multi-purpose vehicles, the Carnival, or our amazing hybrid or electric vehicles. Kia of Auburn is a proud supporter of Auburn Athletics. Kia of Auburn, where you're always number one. Oh, Rico.
You're listening to Auburn Basketball. Now more of the CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off.
Jacob Hillman here with you back in our Auburn Sports Network studios, bringing in Brad Law from Columbia for his keys to the game, presented by Kia of Auburn. And to start off, I think talking about South Carolina's three-point shooting and both of its marquee wins shot the ball really well from three-point. How does Auburn go about defending that?
You can't let them get in catch-and-shoot situations, and you have to close them out completely. There are a couple of guys on this roster with really long range from three. We're talking Michi Johnson will shoot not just with a toe behind the line, but with a good 3 feet behind the three-point line. G.G. Jackson doesn't mind shooting from long range. So there are a couple of guys who will catch and try to shot fake and drive, but there are a lot of guys who will also not mind taking a really deep three. So close out all the way. And have a hand in the face, have a hand up when you go to close out at all times.
And Jalen Williams, he's caught fire these last few games, averaging 15.7 points per game and shooting 53% from the floor. How do you keep him on fire?
Well, get him touches early. He needs to see the ball go in the basket early. Doing that will continue to increase his confidence. He had 21 points on the road a couple of games ago. I mean, Jalen sees the ball go in early, confidence goes up. You know he's going to give you what you need at the other end of the floor. You know you'll get rebounding and assists. Get the ball to go in the hole early, and I think you'll see another big night from Jalen in one-on-one post-up matchups.
All right, thank you very much, Brad. We look forward to your call with the voice of the Tigers, Andy Burcham. Brad's keys to the game are presented by Kia of Auburn, where you're always number one, and this medical report is brought to you by East Alabama Health. Need emergency care? Check out the new freestanding emergency department located in their new Auburn Medical Pavilion in the Auburn Research Park. As you heard Coach Pearl say in his interview with Andy Burcham, Chris Moore, he's rested out, went through warm-ups, and he probably won't play today. So that's something to keep an eye on in the future games and see when we can get Chris Moore back. Straight ahead, we have starting lineups and tip-off of Auburn and South Carolina at Colonial Life Arena. We take one more break before we get to the action in Columbia. This is the Auburn Sports Network.
Tiger Talk has been Auburn's weekly coaches show for over 30 years. Join Bruce Pearl and other Auburn coaches every Thursday night at 6 Central. Send questions by tweeting at AU Sports Network or by emailing aubtigertalk@gmail.com. Tiger Talk is presented by Alpha Insurance. Don't miss Tiger Talk, Thursdays at 6 Central, only on the Auburn Sports Network.
Hey, Tiger fans, this is Andy Burcham. The Auburn experience, you know it. There's nothing else like it. It's what binds us together as the Auburn family. And when you give to Auburn, you build on a strong foundation. Your gift opens doors of opportunity for top students, recruits exceptional faculty, and fuels innovative research. This is what creates our unique Auburn experience. And your gift makes it possible today and for generations to come. Give today at auburngiving.org.
The passion, the tradition, the rivalries. SiriusXM is your destination for all things college sports, and we've got your school covered. On SEC Radio, there's complete coverage of every school in the conference, including live games, plus 24/7 talk and analysis. So cheer along online or on the SiriusXM app and listen to your favorite team anywhere. And now, as a college student, you can stream your first 3 months of SiriusXM for $1. Fees and taxes apply. See offer details and subscribe now at SiriusXM.com/SEC Sports.
CBNS Bank has a long history of stability and a legacy of serving our community's needs for generations. You could say we know a thing or two about tradition. We've been family, community, and financially strong since we began in 1906. Being a team player is part of our culture. That's why at CBNS Bank, we are proud supporters and huge fans of Auburn basketball. Whoa, Regal, hey! Visit cbsbank.com today. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
This is Auburn basketball, and these are the Yellowwood starting lineups for the Tigers.
Drives to the hole, gets a guy in the air, goes up, and makes the shot with a pot on the play. Three ball, Zep Jasper, yes! Oh, Zep for three!
Zep Jasper, senior, Augusta, Georgia, Lucy C. Laney High School.
Went into the hole off the glass, got it at the buzzer! Wendell pops a long three, got it!
Oh. I'm going to get his autograph if he keeps playing like this.
Wendell Green Jr., Junior, Detroit, Michigan, Lillamere High School.
19-footer, switch, it was a three! Flanagan, fourth three, bang! Ahead Flanagan to the hole, with the left-hand hammer!
Allen Flanagan, senior, Little Rock, Arkansas, Parkview High.
Cross court, right wing, Williams, three, got it! It's a steal! Jalen Williams on a breakaway, left-hand hammer! Jalen another three, got it!
Jalen Williams, senior, Mahunta, Georgia, Bramley County High School.
Inside the arc, put it up underneath for Broom, to the hole and in! Broom behind the defense, puts it in! Underneath, Broom with a double hand stuff!
Jannot Broom, sophomore, Plant City, Florida, Ken McCaffrey.
Introducing the first stain worthy of the yellow tag. From the makers of Yellowwood brand pressure treated pine comes Yellowwood Protector. After all, if it's good enough to earn that little yellow tag, then it's the perfect finish for your five-star backyard.
Auburn is 15-3 overall, 5-1 in the SEC, ranked 16th in the AP poll, 17th in the coaches poll, 20 in the NCAA net, and 15 in the KenPom rankings. South Carolina is 8-10, 1-4 in the SEC, 281 in the NCAA net, and 237 in the KenPom rankings. Lamont Harris is the head coach out of Worcester. He graduated there in 1996. In his fifth season as a head coach, came to South Carolina from Chattanooga. His overall record, 95-82. They go with a small lineup today. Michi Johnson at the point, 6'2 sophomore from Cleveland, Tennessee, a transfer from Ohio State, 12.5 points, 4 rebounds, 3.4 assists. Chico Carter on one wing, a 6'1 senior from Columbia, South Carolina, a transfer from Murray State, 11 points, 2.1 rebounds. Jacoby Wright at the other wing, a 6'2 sophomore from Fort Mill, South Carolina, and Legacy Early College. He's averaging 5.7 points, 2.7 rebounds per ball game. And then on the inside, Hayden Brown, 6'5", 234-pound grad student from Greer, South Carolina, a transfer from the Citadel, 11.1 points, 4.9 rebounds, and Gregory G.G. Jackson II. 6'9", a freshman, 215 pounds from here in Columbia, played at Ridgeview High School, averaging 15.1 points, 6.5 rebounds per ballgame. He led Ridgeview to back-to-back state championships, the highest recruit in South Carolina history. Auburn, of course, coached by Bruce Pearl in his ninth season at Auburn, a record of 181-101 in his 28th season overall. His record is 643-246. The SEC officials today, Bart Lennox, Rob Rourke, and Lucas Santos. A little bit of a late arriving crowd, but they have filled in nicely here at the Colonial Life Arena, and there's plenty of orange and blue throughout the stands here today as the Tigers get ready to wrap up a two-game road swing at South Carolina. Auburn is in the away orange uniforms, tops and bottoms, with the blue numerals and lettering and the white trim. South Carolina in the home white uniforms with the garnet numerals and lettering and the black trim here today. Along with Brad Law, I'm Andy Bertram, Jacob Hillman in our Auburn Sports Network studios, Anthony Lowe running the controls in our Skyview studios in Phoenix. It will be jumped up between Gigi Jackson of South Carolina and Jani Broome, and South Carolina wins the tap. They'll be going to the basket to our right to open things up. Michi Johnson, a bounce pass off the left side for Gigi Jackson. Looking at a long three off the left side, it's missed. High rebound pulled in by Allen Flanagan. He had 7 in the first half alone on Wednesday night at LSU. Auburn basketball, there is no score. Broome, left wing. Jasper, top of the circle for Green. Into the lane, Broome to the hole with a two-hand stop.
Get him started early, take advantage of a smaller South Carolina lineup. Go to your big man, give him an isolation touch, let him make a move to the basket.
They doubled up on Wendell, and Broome was open for the unfettered tunk, and Auburn leads 2-0, 19-13 in the first half of play. Jacoby Wright, now to Brown. Backdoor pass, shot is up, and it's good for Chico Carter.
There's a great respect for Carter's outside shooting ability, and that time he drove and was able to get by his man.
3-2 Auburn, 18-57 in the first half of play. At the right sideline, Wendell Green. Green lobs it to the low post. It didn't get there. South Carolina with a steal. Jacoby Wright hands the ball to Johnson up the floor for the Gamecocks. Between the circles, Johnson. Top of the circle, Brown. Drives on Zepp. Knocks him down. That's going to be a charge. Something that Bruce Pearl talked about in the film today, Brad.
Hayden Brown, the tendency for him is to do a quick head fake and then drive. Zepp Jasper didn't bite on the head fake. He kept his feet on the floor, stayed in position, and then was in position to take the charge when Brown leaned forward.
3-2 Auburn. Tiger ball, Flanagan right wing, top of the circle, Broome. Back to the wing for Flanagan. Now top of the key for Wendell. To the left wing, Zepp. Down the low post outside the lane. Broome with a spin to the hole, double hand dunk. Oh, baby. Jani Broome with 4 early on.
He can do that all night in one-on-one matchups against a smaller body. Jani has really quick footwork. We saw the drop step and the spin and all alone to the hoop.
4-2 Auburn on top, 18-05 in the first. Right to the wing, 3 ball in the air. Brown, air ball, weak side rebound Flanagan. They're 0 of their first 2-3 shots. Green on the wing, behind the back dribble, bounce pass to Broome. Faces the basket, down to the baseline, double team to the wing, Green, top of the circle, Flanagan. Now Jasper penetrates, gets the ball to Wendell from 17 feet, good! 6-2 Auburn, 17-35 in the first half.
First three shots Auburn has taken are shots that they would like to get and are great getting all night. 2 right at the bucket shots by Broome and then the pull-up J from the free throw line by Green.
G. Jackson between the circles, working on Jalen Williams. Drives on Williams, head fake, turnaround jumper. It is up, it is missed. The rebound to Broome, Auburn the other way. Wendell across midcourt, top of the circle, steps into a three and buries it. And that's the start you wanted for Auburn. The Tigers have made their first 4 shots. And with 17:08 to go on the first half, Auburn jumps out to a 9-2 lead.
We talked about Jalen Williams in pregame getting confidence from seeing shots go in early. Same thing applies to almost any player. Wendell Green Jr. knocks down the free throw line jumper, and he made up his mind, I think, when he got the ball. I'm coming down and I'm pulling the string when I get into front court. So he's got the range, he's got the confidence, and Lamont Paris not fooling around here. He wants to try to put a cap on this run early.
And he brings his big into the ballgame. Yeah. Josh Gray, who we thought would start today, a 7-footer out of Brooklyn, New York, a transfer from LSU. And a definite stopper on the low post is now in for South Carolina. So this is the lineup we thought we would see. Johnson, Carter, Brown, Jackson, and Gray.
Yeah, Gray at 7 feet tall. Just, it's a different matchup, a bigger body against Jani Broome, who took advantage of a matchup with a 6'5 Hayden Brown a couple of times to open the game.
9-2 Auburn, 17:05 to go in the first half of play. Michi Johnson off the left side, a little bit of pressure by Auburn. Gigi Jackson has it on the left side of the key. Gets a screen from Brown, brings it to the point. Leaves it there for Johnson. Off the left side, it's Gray. Outside the arc, Gray. Right wing, it comes for Jackson, picked up by Zepp. Top of the circle for Brown. Brown picked up the dribble. Picked up by Flanagan. Bounce pass to Johnson. Left wing, shot clock at three. Long range three, he missed it. And the rebound underneath, and a foul on the rebound, I think it's going to go against Janai.
Yep.
He was trying to ward off Josh Gray, the 7 foot, 255 pound junior, and Janai was whistled for the foul, and Carolina has it.
And was very close to a hook on the play as well.
Inbound Gray, left side of the key, to the top for Chico Carter. Carter, with a lot of range, shoots the three and makes it.
That's the scouting report on Carter. He will pull it. He will shoot. He's shooting 50% from three in SEC game.
9-5 Auburn. Wendell across midcourt. Bounce pass top of the circle for Williams. Underneath, Janai. Left wing, Zepp. Three ball in the air. It's short. Rebound to the floor. Picked up by G.G. Jackson for South Carolina. Here's Michi Johnson the other way for the Gamecocks. G.G. Jackson on the wing. Picked up by Flanagan. They clear it out. Pull up 19-footer by Jackson. Didn't get it. Weak side rebound, Roy. Josh Gray throws it away to Jasper. Up the floor, and he's fouled at midcourt by Chico Carter, and that will be the second foul on South Carolina, and it takes us to a timeout break. 15:57 to go in the first. Auburn 9, South Carolina 5. Tiger ball when we come back. Cardwell and KD coming into the Auburn lineup. Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
Auburn Bank celebrates Hall of Fame coach Sonny Smith as color analyst on the Auburn Sports Network. This is Sonny Says.
It's the right call. And UCF keeps the basketball.
Yeah, I was getting ready to get on him, but honesty never has been one of my strongest points.
Or math.
When it, oh, math more so. When it comes to referee, honesty has never been a big thing for me.
Sonny Says is presented by Auburn Bank, champions of you.
Southern homes are particularly vulnerable to termites. In this climate, you need guaranteed protection. You need Cook's Pest Control and Centricon. Termites attack the Centricon stations, exposing themselves to an agent that eliminates their entire colony. Upgrade from old-fashioned liquid service to the proven protection of Centricon and Cook's Pest Control. Call Cook's today for a free evaluation.
Looky, looky, looky.
This is Auburn head coach and proud Ford F-150 owner, Bruce Pearl. The thing I hear most when people get in the cab of my F-150 is, this truck is huge. Well, I drive around some pretty big players, and when I get a 7-footer in the back seat and he's able to spread out, he's just blown away at how roomy and comfortable this truck is. So visit your local Ford dealer and check out Ford F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers.
Not all models, trims, or features may be available. Contact your dealer for more information.
Auburn basketball is brought to you by Alabama Power. At Alabama Power, we give 100% to achieve 99.9% dependability. Our commitment helps deliver power for a better Alabama.
15:57 to go in the first half at Colonial Life Arena in Columbia. Auburn on top of South Carolina by a score of 9-5. Auburn basketball is brought to you by East Alabama Health. With more than 70 new physicians added in the past 4 years, they're growing their healthcare team to meet the growing needs of Auburn, Opelika, and the surrounding area. Auburn off to a good start offensively, 4 of 5 from the field. South Carolina, 2 of 7 from the field, and 1 of 4 from three to open this ballgame. Tiger lineup coming out of the timeout break. Dylan Cardwell and Katie Johnson coming in for Auburn, replacing Jasper and Broom. They join Flanagan, Williams, and Green on the floor for the Tigers.
I like so far that 4 of South Carolina's 7 shots are coming from three, over 50%, and only 2 of Auburn's 5 shots have come from beyond the arc.
Flanagan the inbound, Dylan Cardwell. Left side of the circle, Jalen Williams. Gets the ball to Wendell Green at the top. To Jalen. Had the three, didn't take it. Now backed up with a pass to Wendell. Almost to midcourt. Shot clock at 18. Wendell with a screen from Jalen. Gets it to Jalen. Pops the three, does Jalen. It's short. And the rebound run down in the corner by G.G. Jackson for South Carolina. Across midcourt, guarded by Flanagan. Off the left side to Michi Johnson. Picked up by Wendell Green. Johnson maintains the dribble, now picks it up in between the circles. Gets it top of the key for Hayden Brown. Down the lane against Cardwell. Put it up. High arching shot, missed it. And the rebound, Flanagan clears to Wendell up the floor. Wendell leaves for Flanagan. Left wing three ball. Nope. And the long rebound pulled up by Michi Johnson for South Carolina. Johnson with a screen, top of the circle. Rides right side pass for Carter. Kicks it into the corner left side for Brown. Skip pass, Jackson on the wing. Drives on Flanagan, gets bumped, shoots, and missed it. And the rebound pulled in by Allen. Here's Auburn the other way. Wendell spins, right wing, head fake by Jalen. Into the lane, kicks it into the corner. Three ball, KD, didn't get it. Auburn's missed his last three threes. Take that last four threes, and South Carolina has the ball.
Pace of play is in Auburn's favor right now. They'd like this to be an up-tempo game and try to get into the South Carolina bench.
Jackson outside the arc, right wing, guarded by Wendell. Top of the circle for Brown. Brown left-hand dribble out to the top. Chico Carter with a long three. Didn't get it. It was short. Rebound at Flanagan. Outlet Wendell Green. Tigers up 9-5 with the ball. 14-12 in the first. Wendell backs it up. High post pass for Dylan Cardwell. One dribble, hands now to Jalen. Leaves it for Wendell with 17 to shoot. Green working on Michi Johnson. Gets the screen. Drives down the right side of the lane. Lobs it. Cardwell with a double hand alley-oop.
A lot of action on the backside. Jalen Williams came on the backside of a screen, and that drew the defender's eyes long enough for Cardwell to slip away on the pick and roll, wide open to the basket.
11-5, Auburn on top, 13-40 in the first half of play. Carter, Brown down the lane, runs through Cardwell, and that's another charging foul on Hayden Brown.
A lot of focus in preparation for games on guys who tend to commit offensive fouls on the other team.
Charge bait
is what they're called. And that was in the scouting report. And now Brown, a starter and one of the sturdier bodies for South Carolina, has to come out of the game.
Lior Berman and Trey Donaldson into the Auburn lineup right now. Donaldson at the point, left wing KD with a screen from Broom on the wing. Head fake at three, top of the circle for Trey. Trey crossover, left side of the circle. Out to the top for Jalen, 14 to shoot. Jalen to the hole, off the glass, it didn't go. Rebound tapped, and South Carolina comes out of there. Here's Jacoby Wright up the floor for the Gamecocks. Leaves for G.G. Jackson. One-on-one against Jalen. Down the lane, ball knocked away by Trey. Here's Auburn the other way, 3-on-2. Trey, left wing, KD, head fake at three. Penetrates to the hole, buries the shot as he drives to the basket.
Smart decision, KD Johnson. Saw the defender coming, still a good look from three. Not as high a percentage shot, though, as the drive all the way to the rack.
That's our Sun South drive of the game. Sun South John Deere, preferred tractor of the Tigers. Find your local dealer at sunsouth.com. 13-5 Auburn, 12-42 in the first half of play. Carter, picked up by Lior. They give him to the right wing. He picks up the dribble. Hands it to the big man down the right side for Carter, out into the left corner. Out to the wing it comes to Jacoby Wright. Shot clock at three, a whistle and a foul is going to go against Auburn. I think Trey Donaldson. It's his first, it's the second against Auburn, and it bailed South Carolina out. And Johan Traor is in the Auburn lineup right now. Broom, Donaldson, Berman, and KD, the other four. South Carolina ball, right between the circles for Michi Johnson. Works on Berman, blows past him to the hole. He didn't get it, but got fouled by Lior.
Yep.
And Michi will go to the line to shoot two, 68% from the stripe.
He just got a quick first step on Lior, and you want to try to make him go to the left. He was able to go to the right side of the lane that time, and he finishes much better on that side. Coming out, by the way, was G.G. Jackson, and he's frustrated. He's off to an 0-for-4 start from the floor.
Johnson's free throw is good.
He was slapping the side of his leg with a towel, and off to a frustrating start offensively, thanks to the terrific defense that Auburn is playing.
South Carolina is 2 of 10 from the field. Auburn 6 of 11. Johnson makes both free throws. That stops a run by Auburn. Tigers up 13-7. Donaldson across midcourt to KD Johnson in the key, down the lane. Hangs, goes up, missed it. And it was pulled in by Benjamin Bozeman Verdonk. And he was fouled by KD.
Yeah, that's the old 2-for-1 there. Verdonk blocked the shot and then drew the foul. KD had his shot blocked and then committed the foul out of frustration, trying to get the play back.
Verdonk, a transfer from Illinois, 6'9", a redshirt junior out of Belgium. 13-7, Auburn, 12-02. First half of play, Carolina ball right between the circles. Jacoby, a sophomore from Fort Mill, South Carolina. Left wing for Chico Carter, picked up by Berman. Now to Verdonk, top of the key. Looking right, looking left, throws it off the right side for Wright. On to Donaldson, drives the basket, and Bloom just blocked it. He may have blocked that with his elbow out of bounds. And I'm not exaggerating either. 11:42 to go in the first half. One on the shot clock for South Carolina. When we come back, Auburn 13, South Carolina 7. And this is the Auburn Sports Network.
From Auburn to Corvallis to Omaha, the Tigers are going to the College World Series.
February 17th, the Tigers return to the Diamond.
Here comes Ware. He makes the catch going to his knees.
Bases clearing double by Cole Foster.
This is your home for Auburn baseball.
That one sails into the night and over the wall.
He struck him out swinging. A complete game victory for Joseph Gonzalez.
The Auburn Sports Network.
Hello there. My name is Seychelle, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is the punch of flavors that's unlike any other. You get the crispy tenderness of the chicken and that hint of sourness from the pickles. Ta-da!
Hey, I'm Juan, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is you know you're gonna get chicken that's crispy, golden, and juicy. This is the gold standard of chicken sandwiches.
Order the original Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich on the Chick-fil-A app today. Real customers paid for their testimonials.
We always picture the SEC student athlete for their speed, their vertical, their agility, but it's time we picture them for more, for their campus voice, their community outreach, and for the simple fact that 20 years later, they're still someone's pride and joy. More than students, more than athletes. In the SEC, it just means more.
Welcome back to Columbia, South Carolina.
Back in our Auburn Sports Network studios. Get a check of the Yellowwood scoreboard. Vanderbilt able to hold on at Georgia to win 85-82. That snaps Georgia's 10-game home winning streak. It's a battle at Rupp Arena. Texas A&M and Kentucky are tied at 53 with 9:33 to go in that ball game. And in some top 25 action currently going on, number 5 UCLA and number 11 Arizona. The Wildcats lead at 51-41 over the Bruins with 5:38 to go in that ball game. Back to Columbia with Andy Burcham and Brad Law.
13-7, Auburn on top, 11:42 to go in the first half. First half is presented by Southern Union, conveniently located just a few miles from Auburn. Southern Union offers classes that easily transfer to the university. Endless opportunities are right up the road. Along with Brad Law, Jacob Hillman, I'm Andy Burcham. Tigers out shooting 50%, 6 of 12. Auburn 1 of 5 from 3. South Carolina 2 of 11 from the field. And also 1 of 5 from the 3-point stripe. For Auburn right now, Johan Traor, Janai Broome, Leor Berman, Trey Donaldson, and KD Johnson.
One on the shot clock here for South Carolina. That was obviously something stressed in the huddle. You can't have to be ready to defend a quick catch and shoot.
They will trigger baseline right. It will come from Zachary Davis. He lobs it inbound. Shot is up. It's missed, and it did not catch iron. That was really good defense by Trey Donaldson, who was oversized by G.G. Jackson, and Auburn gets the ball in the shot clock violation.
It's a really quick rest for Jackson. Again, this South Carolina bench doesn't go very deep. That's why I think you'd like to see Auburn play an up-tempo, maybe faster than usual this game today.
Traor lobs it right side for Donaldson. Look to the corner and now hands the ball to Berman, right back to Donaldson. Free throw line, Broome, 13-footer. It didn't go. In and out. And Verdonk gets the rebound for South Carolina.
Gamecocks are keeping Auburn off the offensive glass. No offensive rebounds yet for the Tigers.
E.G. Johnson between the rings picks up the dribble to the right wing for Davis and a three. He missed it. Rebound to K.D. Johnson up the left sideline for the Tigers. To Broome at the point. Has to put it on the floor. Gets the ball to Trey Donaldson. Lane to the basket. Kicks it to the corner. Traor. A three, it's good. Johan Traor from the left corner, his fourth of the year.
Speaking of confidence, Johan Traor gets free in the left corner. The drive by Donaldson drew the defender, left Traor open for the three.
Auburn's largest lead now 9 points with 10:35 in the first half of play. Johnson drives, kicks it to the corner. Carter, Davis to the top. G.G. Jackson for a long three. In and out. Rebound to the floor, and Broom runs it down and then gets fouled from behind. Let's hope everybody's all right. There were bodies flying. Didn't want to see Janai get hit from behind, but he was. And the foul went against Benjamin Bozeman. No, who?
Zachary Davis.
Thank you.
Yeah. It's true. In this role, I don't have to just make hand signals, do I?
No, you can actually speak. We welcome it. His first foul. Auburn up by 9 with the ball. At the top, Auburn working against his own right now. Donaldson penetrates to Johnson. Corner, Traore, 3. This was short. Rebound, weak side, Berman. To the wing for Donaldson. Lobs it underneath for Johan. Reverse layup. Nobody's fouled in the play.
I like the aggressiveness, and the coaches like the confidence in Traore. You made the first shot. Keep shooting. Go attack the offensive glass like Berman did, and go right back to Traore. Give him another chance to put the ball in the basket.
Johan Traore, of course, Auburn's second highest recruit ever behind Jabari from a year ago. At the line for 2, the first is missed. The foul was against Verdonk. That is his first. And Auburn goes to its bench, bringing Alan Flanagan and Zepp Jasper back into the lineup. As Berman sits down for the Tigers, so does KD. Traore's second free throw, it didn't go. And the rebound to G.G. Jackson for South Carolina. Auburn by 9 with under 10 minutes to go in the first half of play. Bounce pass at the top. Verdonk picks up the dribble, drives on Broom, gets picked up by Flanagan, out to the top for Jackson. Down the lane, Jackson to the hole with a left hand. He missed it, got his own rebound, goes back up and scores.
Well, Jackson is going to shoot the ball. He has 8 of their 16 attempts on the game.
15 points a ball game for the freshman. Low post pass. Broom to the corner. Jasper out to the top. Donaldson underneath and out of bounds. He thought that Flanagan was going to drive along the baseline, and Allen did not. And, Donaldson comes out, so does Traore, as Wendell Green Jr. and Jalen Williams return to the Auburn lineup. This is Auburn starting 5. Green, Jasper, Flanagan, Williams, and Broom.
Valuing the basketball, that's just the second turnover in the first half of the first half. Tigers need to, it's going to be a key all season long for this team.
9-18 in the first, Auburn up 16-9, and South Carolina turns the ball right back over. To Flanagan, penetrates down the lane to the hole off the glass. It didn't go, but Broom is there for the putback. South Carolina wanted basket interference. Janai was 6 points early on. Tigers by 9 again. 18-9, South Carolina ball, G.G. Jackson. At the top for Bozeman, Verdonk to the right wing for Jackson. G.G. hands the ball there. Davis out to the top of the circle for Johnson. Michi. Top of the circle, working on, he drug the pivot foot big time, and then they throw it out of bounds underneath.
Sped him up.
Sure did. That's a good point.
Sped him up. Got him playing a little faster. South Carolina is a team, maybe more so than anybody else in the league. They want to run the shot clock down. They want to play at a measured pace and take a shot within the last 5-6 seconds of the shot clock. Auburn's defense is speeding them up and making them play faster than they want to play, and that's 6 first-half turnovers for South Carolina.
Josh Gray, the 7-footer, is back into the lineup on the low post, replacing Bozeman Verdonk. Auburn ball. Green looks to the bench, gets the call. South Carolina back in a man. Right wing, Jasper. Top of the circle, Williams. Left wing, Flanagan. Look to the low post. Wants to get it to Broom. Instead, to the top for Green. Wendell with 10 on the shot clock. Drives right side. Leaves it at the top. Williams, 3, ball straight away. Short. Got his own rebound. Drives to the hole. Gets his man up in the air and scores. Jalen's first bucket of the game gives Auburn his first double-digit lead of the game.
And after not getting an offensive rebound in the first 9 or 10 minutes, Tigers have grabbed 3 in the last 2 or 3.
20-9 Auburn, G.G. Jackson at the top, higher arching shot, missed it, Gray rebounds. Out to the perimeter, Chico Carter for 3. In and out, rebound Gray, into the corner, Johnson. 3 ball there, no good, weak side rebound Broom for Auburn. South Carolina now 1 of 9 from 3. Green spins down the left side of the lane and loses the ball. Steal by Jackson. Ahead for South Carolina. To Carter on the wing. To the corner. 3 ball in the air. Davis, no. Rebound Jasper for Auburn. Oh, he had Wendell Green wide open at the other end. Instead, he goes underneath for Broom. Hands the ball to Wendell on the left wing. Tigers by 11 with 7:16 in the first. Underneath Janai, up for a shot, it was blocked. Here Carolina the other way. Johnson to Davis to the hole, good. Zachary Davis's first bucket of the ball game, and it's a 20-11 Auburn lead.
They took a lot of shots and a lot of time went off the clock for them to finally wind up with that bucket. That's one of those win the battle, lose the battle, win the war type plays.
Wendell Green gives to Broom, who dunks it home. Nice give by Green, and Janai Broom has 8.
They're pulling Gray away from right underneath the basket, and that's leaving that area wide open for Janai.
22-11 Auburn, 6:33 on a counting clock in the first half. Michi Johnson picked up by Broom in a switch. Off the left side, it goes for Davis. Skip pass, Jackson, 3-ball, good. 5 points for the talented freshman out of Ridgeview High School here in Columbia.
5 points on 10 shots already, 10 of their 22. He's gonna pull the string.
22-14 Auburn. Wendell gets bumped by Davis, pops a three. He missed it, but he was fouled by Davis.
Boy, Davis said, if they don't call the first foul, I'll just foul him again.
That's his second foul of the game. And after this timeout, Wendell Green goes to the line to shoot three. 6:05 remaining in the first half at the Colonial Life Arena in Columbia. Auburn 22, South Carolina 14. Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
This is the moment you've been waiting for.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our home.
When you step onto the court and into the spotlight, the moment to show that hard work and long days pay off. Because when that final shot leaves your hands and we leave our seats, that powerful moment connects us all.
Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Power for a better Alabama.
Hey Tiger fans, this is Andy Burcham. The Auburn experience, you know it. There's nothing else like it. It's what binds us together as the Auburn family. And when you give to Auburn, you build on a strong foundation. Your gift opens doors of opportunity for top students, recruits exceptional faculty, and fuels innovative research. This is what creates our unique Auburn experience. And your gift makes it possible today and for generations to come. Give today at auburngiving.org.
Hello there. My name is Seychelle, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is the punch of flavors that's unlike any other. You get the crispy tenderness of the chicken and that hint of sourness from the pickles. Ta-da!
Hey, I'm Juan, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is you know you're going to get chicken that's crispy, golden, and juicy. This is the gold standard of chicken sandwiches.
Order the original Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich on the Chick-fil-A app today. Real customers paid for their testimonials.
Auburn basketball is brought to you by Chick-fil-A. All Chick-fil-A locations in Alabama proudly support the Auburn Tigers.
6:05 to go in the first half. Auburn on top 22-14 at South Carolina. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification on the Auburn Sports Network. Andy Burcham along with Brad Law with you from Colonial Life Arena. Good crowd on hand today for Auburn and to South Carolina. Big group of Auburn fans making the trip over, including a bus sponsored by the Auburn Tip-Off Club. And you can see the orange and blue throughout the stands here, especially the lower bowl, which is nice. Typically, they're in the hinterlands of arenas like this.
Hinterlands. A lot of the Carolina crowd was late arriving. They filled in the seats a little closer to tip. About 15 minutes out, though, it almost looked like a neutral site game.
Yeah.
It almost looked legitimately a 50-50 split. A lot more Garnet has come in since then.
Auburn has outscored South Carolina off turnovers 8-0. Leads the Gamecocks points in the paint 14-6 and off the bench 7-2. Dylan Cardwell checking in for Auburn at the timeout break, replacing Janai Broom, who's off to a nice start, isn't he?
He absolutely is. He's gotten a lot of really close looks. He's used the one-on-one matchup, and Janai thus far.
Four of six.
8 points, 4 rebounds.
First free throw by Wendell is good. It's the first of three for Wendell. Auburn basketball brought to you by Ford. Check out the Ford F-150 at your local Ford dealer. F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. Second free throw hits the iron, hits the glass, and rolls in for Wendell Green Jr. And Auburn is back up by 10 with 6:05 to go in the first half of play. Auburn has led by as many as 11. And Wendell missed the free throw. And that snaps a string of 25 consecutive free throws made by Wendell Green Jr. 24-14 Auburn. Right picked up by Flanagan. Off the left side, a pass for Hankins Sanford. To the top for Brown, who has two fouls in this first half. Brown picks up the dribble, needs to get rid of it, does out to the top for Sanford. Sanford, top of the circle for Johnson. Down the lane, lobs it off the glass and scores. Auburn by 8, 5:32 to go, first half of play. Wendell across midcourt for the Tigers. To Dylan Cardwell at the point. Outside the arc, one dribble now to Wendell. Off the left side of the key. 15 to shoot for the Tigers. Wendell, long three, Green, nope. Rebound, Cardwell in traffic, loses it. It goes out of bounds, and that is South Carolina ball. That's the wrong call, friends.
Yeah, it's got to be. Dylan had control of that ball. It was swiped away from his hands and out of bounds.
Yep. South Carolina gets it on the call, though. 5:09 to go in the first half. Gamecocks basketball. Johnson across midcourt. Watch out for a three here. Johnson between the rings to Sanford. And a silly foul by Jalen Williams outside the arc. First foul on Jalen. That is the fifth foul against Auburn in the half. Carolina was 6. Inbound Brown to Johnson. Skip pass right side for Wright. Wright with the screen to Brown at the top. One dribble, picks it up to Sanford. He's open for a three, doesn't take it. Drives on Cardwell. Drop step, right hand hook, good.
I think you'll live with that shot. He might have gotten a little deeper than you'd like, but a one-on-one turnaround jumper against Dylan. Auburn's okay with that shot.
Carolina has made its last 4 field goals. Cut the lead to 6, Auburn ball. Jasper, left wing. Flanagan, crowd trying to get back into this ball game. Allen drives behind the back dribble, goes baseline, gets double teamed. Free throw line, Jalen to the hole. Yes, and a foul! Oh, what a shot by Jalen Williams down the left side of the lane.
That was not a part of the set play. Jalen saw that there was trouble on the left side of the floor, so he cut to the basket. He gave Zepp a lane to throw the ball into with momentum toward the bucket and then took a fierce bump and was able to get it to fall.
Brown picks up his 3rd foul.
Yeah.
And he will immediately come back out of the ball game. Jalen at the free throw line, 4 points in this one. 74% free throw shooter is Jalen Williams. And he got it. Well, it almost came out of there, but it stayed in. 3-point play for Auburn. Wendell Green out right now. Trey Donaldson in at the point. Tigers up 27-18. Carolina ball. Johnson between the rings. He has terrific range. Does Michi Johnson and Chico Carter both. Left wing, Gigi Jackson. Jackson on the left wing to right at the top. Left side, into the corner. Chico Carter, guarded by Flanagan. 4 to shoot in the lane. Head fake goes up. He didn't get it, but he got fouled.
So he's going to earn a trip to the line, and it was a foul on Flanagan, but I'm so impressed with Zepp Jasper's defense on that play against Gigi Jackson. They got the one-on-one matchup in the post, and Jackson's got a height advantage. Zepp got in front of him like he was boxing him out for a rebound from the front. Really tenacious defensively, didn't let him get the touch in late.
3:45 to go in the first, Auburn 27, South Carolina 18. Gamecock shoot free throws when we come back, and this is the Auburn Sports Network.
The Auburn Basketball Review is your weekly recap and preview of what's happening with the Tigers. Highlights, interviews, special features, plus Bruce Pearl's breakdown of what the Tigers are doing in the week ahead. Find the show on stations throughout Alabama, Valley Sports Southeast, the Auburn Tigers channel on YouTube, and auburntigers.com. Look for the Auburn Basketball Review this weekend.
Southern homes are particularly vulnerable to termites. In this climate, you need guaranteed protection. You need Cook's Pest Control and Centricon. Termites attack the Centricon stations, exposing themselves to an agent that eliminates their entire colony. Upgrade from old-fashioned liquid service to the proven protection of Centricon and Cook's Pest Control. Call Cook's today for a free evaluation.
Looky, looky, looky.
Thanks for choosing Whataburger. What can I get started for you?
At Whataburger, each meal is made to order, so you can always get exactly what you crave. If that's a Whataburger, what a meal, you got it. But if you're in the mood for something a little more you, like a Whataburger with grilled onions, crispy bacon, and creamy pepper sauce, go for it. March to the beat of your own drum. Bite into the beef of your own Whataburger creation. Whataburger, just like you like it.
Jacob Hillman back in our Auburn Sports Network studios with a check of the Yellowwood scoreboard. And in Rupp Arena, it's Kentucky on top of Texas A&M 63-59 with 4:38 to go in that ball game. Number 9 Tennessee and LSU are just underway in Baton Rouge. Volunteers lead at 6-4. And number 5 UCLA, number 11 Arizona coming down to the wire. 17 seconds to go in that ball game. Wildcats lead at 56-52. We'll have a full check of the Yellowwood scoreboard at the Connecticut Sausage Halftime Show, coming up in about 4 minutes of game time. Now back to Columbia with Andy Burcham and Brad Law.
All right, Jacob, thank you. 3:45 remaining in the first half. Auburn leads at South Carolina 27-18. Gamecock shooting free throws coming out of the timeout break. If you're searching for that perfect beach home, find your piece of paradise on the Alabama Gulf Coast with the number one RE/MAX agent in Alabama, Mindy Jones with RE/MAX Paradise. Begin your search by visiting Mindy at Paradise. Spell it out, Mindy at Paradise.com. Chico Carter, 57% from the stripe. First free throw is missed. Transfer from Murray State, averaging 11 points and 2 rebounds a game. He is the best three-point shooter in the SEC at 48.6% coming in. And he gets the second free throw to fall. And Auburn's lead is 27-19 with 3:45 in the first. Wendell Green, Jalen Williams, Allen Flanagan, KD Johnson, and Janai Broome, the five for Auburn. Green picks it up, gets the ball to Broome at the top. To Johnson, left wing, top of the circle, Jalen. Back to the left wing, Johnson. Low post, Broome foul from behind. And Auburn maybe caught a little bit of a break. The pass wasn't the best going to the low post, but Daniel Hankins Samford was very aggressive guarding Janai Broome from behind, and Auburn goes to the line for a one and bonus.
Yeah, KD wanted to put the pass on the right shoulder, right hand of Janai, put it on the left instead, and that allowed Hankins Samford to think he could get it.
First free throw is good by Janai Broome, sophomore out of Plant City, Florida. He's from Morehead State, where he was the SEC the Ohio Valley Conference Defensive Player of the Year a year ago. Second free throw, good for Janai. Good to see him knock down both charity tosses. And Auburn is up 10, 29-19.
Janai in double figures before halftime.
3:25 in the first. Left sideline, Chico Carter. Jackson at the top. GG, right-hand dribble, bounce pass off the right side for Samford. Gets a screen, Broome stays with him. Now to Johnson at the top, picked up by KD. Johnson, baseline right, now to the free throw line. Kicks it to the corner for Carter. 15 or 6 to shoot for 3. Carter missed it. Weak side rebound, Jalen Williams. 2, Wendell Green up the floor on the right side. Tigers by 10 and with the ball, 2:56 in the first. Wendell Green between the legs dribble. Gets a screen from Broome down the right side of the lane. Underneath, no. Throws it. Broome's wide open for the dunk.
Oh. And South Carolina sent two players to try to cut off a pass to Jalen Williams. Wendell Green looked them off and threw a no-look to Janai for the dunk.
Auburn up 31-19, 2:33 in the first. Drive out to the top. G.G. Jackson, three ball. Missed it long. Rebound Samford underneath. With the left hand, he missed it. Rebound fought for. Here comes Flanagan for Auburn. Up the left sideline, waits for the numbers. Free throw line, Jalen from 15, swish. Jalen Williams with 7. And Auburn goes up 33-19 with 2:10 in the first half.
And remember, South Carolina cut the lead to 6. Jalen then went in, converted a three-point play.
And a steal by Wendell, but it's knocked right back. Here is Samford drives to the hole, and he puts it up, and he missed the bunny, but it's tapped up and in by G.G. Jackson. That stops a 6-0 run by Auburn. A minute 50 to go in the first half. Auburn up 33-21. Wendell Green across midcourt, gets a screen from Broome. Throws it to Broome, behind the defense, scores! Oh, what a first half for Jani Broome! 14 in the first half.
Samford was a little bit hurt. He looks okay now, but he looked down at his hand, and that left Jani Broome wide open.
35-21, Auburn, a minute 25 in the first half. Long three, left side, Johnson, no. Rebound, saved by Wendell. Here's the Tigers the other way. Leading by 14, Flanagan to the hole with the left-hand hammer. Oh, Alan Flanagan with one of those dunks. An Alan Flanagan dunk, and Auburn has opened up a 16-point lead with 1:10 to go in the first half of play, and a 30-second timeout called by Lamont Paris.
It's not the 4th of July. It's not New Year's Eve, but that was some fireworks from this Auburn team, and it started with Wendell Green Jr. not allowing the ball to go out of bounds and take possession that way. He got it on the baseline. He pushed it up the floor. Again, it's almost a no-look pass to Flanagan, who had the lane to the basket, and then Allen with an aggressive finish.
You remember the dunk against Kentucky last year by Devin Cambridge?
Yeah.
Remember that pass from Wendell Green?
Yes.
Very similar.
Yep.
And it ended the same way. It was a right-handed dunk from Devin, a left-handed hammer by Allen.
What you have to see now becoming a pattern for this Auburn team, get out to a lead, and when the other team makes a run,
respond.
Yeah,
Auburn is 5 of its last 5 since
South
Carolina cut that lead to 6.
It was 25-19 at that point. So that's a 12-2 run.
Right. Green, KD, Flanagan, Williams, and Broome, the 5 for Auburn right now. Carolina basketball after a 30-second timeout. Michi Johnson between the circles. You hear the Let's Go Auburn crowd. Top of the circle, Gray against Jani. Picks up the dribble, almost lost it. Gets the ball to G.G. Jackson. Jackson against Wendell. Left sideline, Michi Johnson. 7 to shoot. Johnson backs it up. Down to 4 to shoot. Johnson drives, lobs it to the corner. And they ran out of time. They ran out of time before a shot was even taken.
I'll tell you what, watching Auburn play defense almost brings a tear to your eye. They are working so hard, and they are exactly where they're supposed to be defensively.
Auburn by 16, Wendell Green quickly into the offense for Auburn. Backs it up, shot clock, game clock about 10 seconds apart. Shot clock at 20. Wendell gets bumped by Davis, no foul called. Gets it to Williams. To Wendell at the right wing. To Williams. Left side. Drives inside. Up from 15. Good!
He must hit 100 of those in practice every day. That's his sweet spot. The little left-handed floater from the elbow.
39-21 Auburn. Final 9 seconds of the first half. G.G. Jackson. Whistle and a foul against Flanagan. And that will put them at the free throw line. With 6.3 seconds to go in the first half, Allen picks up his first foul. And G.G. Jackson, a 63% free throw shooter, is at the line for 1 in bonus, excuse me.
3 of South Carolina's 21 points have come at the free throw line. Auburn has limited them to under 27% from the field.
Jackson's free throw is good. Auburn has outscored South Carolina in the paint, 22-12 here in this first half of play. Auburn has hit its last 6 field goals, and now we'll have 6.3 seconds to get off a shot to end it if it gets a rebound on a Jackson miss or a Jackson make. And he missed it. And the rebound pulled out. It comes to Jackson. Underneath, Gray to the hole. He missed it. Now, Auburn caught a break there. They got a really good look after a missed defensive rebound by Auburn. But what a finish by Auburn. The Tigers make their last 6 field goals and outscore South Carolina 12-3 to end the first half after Carolina cut the lead to 6. At the break in Columbia, Auburn 39, South Carolina 22. Time now for the Kaneka Sausage Halftime Report. to our Auburn Sports Network studios. Here is Jacob Hillman.
Thank you, Andy. And, yeah, strong first half indeed for the Tigers. Jani Broome, leading scorer with 14 points. Now let's take a full check of the Yellowwood scoreboard as Kentucky and Texas A&M are battling in Rupp Arena. The Aggies are trying to remain undefeated in SEC play as they come to Neville Arena on Wednesday. Auburn with the longest home winning streak in the nation at 28 games. If the Aggies are able to pull this one out, that sets up to be a massive matchup. And then number 9, Tennessee and LSU in Baton Rouge. The Volunteers lead it 8-7 with 14:55 to go in the first half. Some games that have gone final, number 25, Arkansas, defeated Ole Miss 69-57. Vanderbilt defeated Georgia 85-82. Later on tonight, number 4, Alabama travels to Missouri at 5 Central, and Florida goes to Mississippi State at 7:30 Central. Top 25 has been wild today as several upsets, close games, have happened today. Number 11, Arizona takes down number 5, UCLA, 58-52. Number 14, TCU takes down Kansas in dominating fashion at Allen Fieldhouse, 83-60. And then Duke, on the upsetting side, not used to saying that, defeats number 17, Miami, 68-66. Number 8, Xavier handled business, winning 95-82. And some games coming down to the wire. Unranked Oklahoma State leading number 12, Iowa State, 61-59, with 3 seconds to go in that ball game. And then number 20, Marquette and Seton Hall are tied early, 12:26 to go in the first half. And then it's number 21, Baylor, leading Oklahoma 10-7 with 14 minutes to go in that ball game. Some other games going on later today that are intriguing. Number 7, Texas goes to West Virginia, the team that Auburn will face in the SEC Big 12 Challenge in 7 days at 5 o'clock Central. Number 19, Clemson hosts Virginia Tech. And then number 6, Gonzaga, lost for the first time at home this week to give Auburn that longest home winning streak in the nation, goes to Pacific at 9 o'clock Central. This is the Konecka Sausage Halftime Show. The Konecka Sausage Company is proud to be the official smoked sausage and hot dog of the Auburn Tigers. Make Konecka Sausage part of your game day and family traditions. Well, it's been an exciting week on the plains with several teams earning big wins and a Final Four banner being hung in Neville Arena. We'll tell you all about it and more when we take a look around Auburn Athletics. This is the Auburn Sports Network.
AuburnTigers.com is the official website of Auburn Athletics. Read the latest feature stories on your favorite Tiger teams. Get critical game day info, search videos and audio. Find how to get connected through social and digital media or by joining Tigers Unlimited. Shop the AU Photo Store or just find the next event on the athletic calendar. Plus, all athletics broadcasts are streamed free at AuburnTigers.com/watch. AuburnTigers.com, the official online home of Auburn Athletics.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat. That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Auburn Athletics, helping the world keep promises.
Head down. He's in. Touchdown, Auburn!
The game has changed, and the future of Auburn Athletics now demands a strong name, image, and likeness program. I'm Andy Burcham, and I urge you to support On to Victory, the name, image, and likeness collective for Auburn student athletes. Please take this opportunity to improve the lives of our players and give our teams the best chance of success. Learn more at ontovictory.com.
When we say we're an everything school, we mean it. Since 1872, Auburn University graduates from the College of Agriculture and the Samuel Ginn College of Engineering have built on the land-grant mission to drive economic development, improve quality of life, promote social well-being, and enhance national security. Celebrating 150 years, come see why Auburn's College of Agriculture and Ginn College of Engineering continue to be pillars of the past, pioneers of the present, and foundations for the future. Visit auburn.edu.
Well, Welcome back to the Kaneka Sausage Halftime Show. Auburn leads South Carolina 39-22 at the break. Jacob Hillman here with you in our Auburn Sports Network studios. So we took a look around Auburn athletics this week, and several Auburn programs have already come away with big wins to open 2023. And we'll start with number 7 gymnastics taking down number 25 Arkansas last night in front of a sold-out Neville Arena. The night began with a banner unveiling for the Tigers' first Final Four in program history this past season in 2022. And from there, Auburn put together a team score of 197.5 to take down the Razorbacks. The Tigers will be back in action on Friday against NC State at Neville Arena at 7 Central. Number 9, Auburn men's swim and dive took down number 15, Alabama, in dominating fashion by 68 points yesterday on Senior Day. The number 13 women put up a heck of a fight against the Crimson Tide, but fell by just 10 points. It was the final dual meet of the season for the Tigers, and the diving teams will compete in a tri meet at Georgia Tech on Friday and next Saturday, and the full swim and dive squads will compete again at the Auburn Invitational in February. Number 15, women's tennis earned a ranked win in its home opener, defeating number 22, Iowa State, 5-2 yesterday. And that just gets the exciting weekend started for the Tigers as they host number 2, North Carolina, tomorrow at 11 a.m. Central, and Samford following that at 4 Central. Both those matches will be held at the Yarborough Tennis Center and are free to attend. On the men's side of tennis, the Tigers are off to a strong 3-0 start in 2023. 7-0 win over Samford on Thursday improved them to that record. And the Tigers will head to Winston-Salem, North Carolina on Friday to face the team that knocked them out of the 2022 NCAA tournament in Wake Forest. So a little bit of revenge on the Tigers' minds there. Indoor track and field was in action yesterday and again today at the Vanderbilt Invite. All-American jumper Dontavius Hill set an indoor personal best as well as the nation's second best high jump, clearing 7 feet and 3 inches. Tigers head to Lubbock, Texas for the Texas Tech Open and Multis Thursday through Saturday. Women's basketball returns home tomorrow for the first time in 2 weeks to host Ole Miss in the annual We Back Pack game. Tip-off is set for 4 Central at Neville Arena. Coverage can be heard locally on FM Talk 93.9 and everywhere on the Auburn Tigers app with Britt Bowen and Dr. Larry DeShera beginning at 3:45. Tickets are available at aubtix.com. And the next men's basketball broadcast will be on Wednesday as Auburn returns to the jungle for the first time with the nation's longest active home game winning streak at 28 games against Texas A&M, who did just fall, is going to fall to Texas, to Kentucky, 75-68 in that game with 11 seconds to go. But tip-off set for 8 Central, and Andy Burcham, Sonny Smith, and Brad Law have the call beginning at 7:30. Again, your score at the half, Auburn 39, South Carolina 22. We take a look at the first half stats when the Kaneka Sausage Halftime Show continues in a moment.
Kaneka Sausage is a product we all know and love, and it's the official sausage and hot dog of the Auburn Tigers. Kaneka Sausage is made from the finest cuts of pork, patented blend of seasonings, all-natural casings, and smoked over a pure hickory fire for that true Southern flavor. Enjoy a crowd-pleasing Kaneka Sausage dog or premium hot dog while watching the Tigers, and make Kaneka part of your game day or any day. Kaneka Sausage is celebrating their 75th year of the Sessions family, making their premium smoked sausage in Evergreen, Alabama. Be sure to visit the new Kaneka gift shop right off I-65 at exit 96.
North American beavers are excellent swimmers, but on land, they waddle about clumsily. That is until they spot the yellow tag on a stack of Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. Their instincts kick in, and the colony springs into action. Just like that, these master builders make off with their newfound building materials.
For five-star backyards, Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it.
In 1925, Modelo began brewing beer for those who believe in better. A model beer, steeped in the tradition of tireless effort. A rich, Pilsner-style lager for those who wear their heart and heritage in their rolled-up sleeve. Since our first batch to every bottle raised today, we've proved that it doesn't matter where you come from. It matters what you're made of. Modelo Especial, brewed for those with a fighting spirit. Drink responsibly. Beer imported by Crown Imports, Chicago, Illinois.
In SEC sports, the ifs come at you every minute. What if your QB had released the ball a second earlier? What if the head coach hadn't used his last timeout? What if your team goes all the way this season? If you love the tradition, if you live for the rivalry, if you can't wait each week for the absolute edge of your seat action,
Regions is right there with you as the official bank of the SEC.
Regions can't help you with the ifs in sports. Regions helps you embrace the if in life.
Member FDIC.
Back to the wing for Flanagan. Now top of the key for Wendell to the left wing, Zepp. Down the low post outside the lane. Broom with a spin to the hole. Double hand dunk.
That was one of the six field goals made by Jani Broom in the first half. He was the leading scorer for the Tigers with 14 points. Jacob Hillman back with you in the Auburn Sports Network studios to tell you halftime numbers are brought to you by the Alabama Department of Public Health. Don't wait. Vaccinate. Protect yourself and others against COVID and flu. Visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM. Number 16, Auburn leads South Carolina 39-22 at the half as we take a look at some of the stats. And, man, Auburn's dominating this game. Finished the half making six of its last six field goals for a 57% shooting percentage. South Carolina, on the other hand, missed six of its last seven field goals for a 26% field goal percentage at the half. Auburn only 2 for 9 from three. South Carolina's 2 for 14. Auburn's only turned the ball over three times, but has forced South Carolina to turn it over seven times. Auburn has turned those turnovers into 10 points and is actually getting out-rebounded 20-16 South Carolina. But when you're making your shots, you're gonna give up. Or excuse me, South Carolina's going to get rebounds. Bench points, Auburn has 7 to South Carolina's 4, but the points in the paint is the big difference. 22 points for Auburn and 12 for South Carolina. Like I said, leading scorer for Auburn, Jani Broom. Alan Flanagan's the leading rebounder with 6. Wendell Green Jr. has 6 assists. And for South Carolina, as you'd expect, is G.G. Jackson leading the Gamecocks with 8 points and 5 rebounds. Those are your halftime stats, and once again, your score at halftime. Auburn 39, South Carolina 22. We will get you back out to Colonial Life Arena for second half action between Auburn and South Carolina with the voice of the Tigers, Andy Burcham and Brad Law, after this.
You've been listening to the Koneka Sausage Halftime Show. Make Koneka Sausage part of your game day. Still family owned and made in Evergreen, Alabama since 1947. The second half is 2 minutes away. This is the Auburn Sports Network.
Hey, Tiger fans. Join Coach Johnny Harris and the Auburn women's basketball staff on the Coach Jay Show. The show airs live on location from Baumhauer's Victory Grill every Monday at 6 p.m. Get the latest updates on the Tigers from Coach Jay while enjoying delicious food from Baumhauer's. The show is available locally on FM Talk 93.9 FM and anywhere else on the Auburn Game Day app. Make your plans now to join us for the Coach Jay Show at Baumhauer's Victory Grill, Mondays at 6. War Eagle!
This just in, Auburn Bank has completed their 114th year of serving their community.
This next one goes out to Auburn Bank, champions of you.
Touchdown, Auburn Bank! The champions of you are 114-0!
Welcome to Auburn Bank. How can we help?
I hear y'all are undefeated.
Helping you achieve your financial goals is our goal. Visit championsofyou.com to see how we can serve you. Auburn Bank, champions of you. Member FDIC.
It's a great day for Auburn Tigers to get vaccinated. COVID and flu vaccines are an important tool to help stop the pandemic. The Alabama Department of Public Health is offering the COVID and flu vaccines to anyone 6 months and older. COVID and flu. The COVID and flu vaccines are safe, effective, and free. COVID and flu are still on the rise. Don't let COVID and flu stop you from supporting your favorite team. Continue to help protect yourself, your friends, and our campus by getting the COVID and flu vaccines. For more information, visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM.
When you see the SEC student athlete, it's easy to picture the swing, the stance, the form. But look closer, and you'll see the heart, the brain, the clutch lab partner, the avid two-stepper, the pride of a hometown, and a little brother's hero. More than students, more than athletes. In the SEC, it just means more.
The Second Half Spark is brought to you by the finest electricians in the world, the brothers and sisters of the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 613.
At the half, Auburn 39, South Carolina 22. Really a strong finish for Auburn. Tigers outscored South Carolina 12-3 in the final few moments of the first half. So, Brad Law, what's your spark to the second half for Auburn?
Same defensive intensity after the performance against LSU Wednesday night in Baton Rouge to come out and limit South Carolina to under 26% shooting is magnificent. It speaks to the focus. This is a quick turnaround for Auburn. They had a day, basically, to prep before they're on the road again, going from one road game to the next. So can they come out and have the same defensive intensity for the first 5 minutes of the second half that they did to close the first half? If so, I think we're celebrating on the way back this afternoon.
Auburn has played two games on the road this week, and Wednesday night the Tigers shot 48% from the field in the first half, even better in the second half. Today, Auburn shoots 57.1% from the field. And Auburn made its last six shots in the first half here today.
Jalen Williams created his own shot several times. Wendell Green Jr., six assists in the first half, created some really good looks for teammates as well. So shot selection is so very important. Auburn took 9 threes, only made 2 of them. If you take away the three-point shots, Auburn was 14 for 19 in the first half.
On the other hand, Carolina was 2 of 14. The one thing you got to watch for is if Carolina gets hot from 3 here in the second half. Auburn will have the ball to open the second half of play. Wendell Green Jr. at the right wing gets the ball to Alan Flanagan. Top of the circle for Williams. Jasper Williams, top of the circle, Broom. Everybody's touched the ball in this possession. Wendell, left side for Jalen. Leaves for Wendell, 15 to shoot. Underneath, tried to get it to Broom. It didn't get there. Brown with the steal for South Carolina. And then he's taken away, and here's Auburn on the break. Wendell Green Jr. to Broom with a left-hand hammer, and a foul on the play.
My goodness.
Boy, Brad, you could see it coming. I just didn't know in what form it was going to come there.
Well, and Janai had to reach back a little bit to get it with the left hand. Those passes are hard to make. And the fact that Wendell could make the pass sliding forward.
And Broom completes the three-point play.
And Janai finish it with the dunk is really impressive.
Auburn by 20, 42-22 with 19:30 to go in the second half of play, South Carolina basketball. Outside the arc, left side, it's Wright. Wright getting the start today rather than the big guy underneath. Oh. At the top, three ball, in and out for South Carolina. Rebound, Brown lost it, and he was fouled by Wendell Green.
It's the 10th offensive rebound in this game for South Carolina. Were it not for the offensive boards, this thing could be really out of hand.
One concerning stat right now, that's it.
And they come in as the sixth best offensive rebounding team in the league. Auburn fourth.
Hayden Brown, grad student out of Greer, South Carolina, misses the first free throw. He's a 67% free throw shooter. Two-time first team All-Southern Conference selection. And his second free throw, he missed that. Ironic that he comes to South Carolina, which at one time was in the Southern Conference before they were in the ACC. Makes you think. Auburn by 20, Tiger ball. Left side, Zepp Jasper. To the top for Williams, down the lane. With the left hand, it didn't go. Rebound, Brown pulls it away from Broom. Brown up the middle of the floor for South Carolina. Off the right wing, three ball, GG. Missed it, rebound, Denai Broom.
You'll give him that shot.
If
he's gonna keep taking it, you'll keep giving it.
Wendell Green at the top, Auburn by 20. 18:39 in the second half. Wendell the hole missed, but Jalen is there for the putback jam.
There's an offensive rebound.
There you go. 18:28, second half. Auburn's lead is 22 points, 44-22. Right, G.G. Jackson penetrates on Jalen, spins to the baseline. Jalen stays with him, fadeaway baseline, right, good. Dude can play.
He's not going to stop shooting either.
No. 44-24, Auburn, 18:09, second half of play. At the top, it's Broom. Left wing, Jasper, to Green with a screen. Off the right side of the circle, now backs it out. 18 minutes to go in the second half, Auburn by 20 at South Carolina. Shot clock at 13, whistle, and a three-second violation. Ooh. I think that's literally the second time that has been called all season long.
I was going to say, I don't think I've seen that since the Clinton administration. Whew.
44-24, Auburn, 17:50 in the second half, South Carolina ball. Michi Johnson between the rings. Jacker Jackson, left wing, back to Jackson, top of the circle. Into the key, down the lane. To the basket with the left hand, nobody's fouled by Janai Broom. Boy, right now it looks like the offense for South Carolina, the strategy is get it to number 23.
It is, and I thought they were getting Janai on that too. Looks like Wendell Green gets called for the foul for on a reach-in.
I beg your pardon.
Or Jalen Williams.
They called Jalen.
Yeah.
Okay. His second foul. Jackson's free throw is good. Five-star recruit, South Carolina Player of the Year. Went for a career-high 24 earlier this season against Eastern Michigan. That was back on December 30th. Back-to-back state championships at Ridgeview High School here in Columbia. Free throw, he missed it. Rebound, Johan Traor for Auburn. Snuck in the game. Well, not literally, but he's in the game for Auburn. At the top is Traor. Into the lane for Broom. Spins against Brown. Up with the left hand. He didn't get it. Rebound, weak side, Flanagan for Auburn. Back out of traffic, out to the top for Wendell. Green guarded by number one, Jacoby Wright. Gets past Wright to the basket. Kicks it underneath Broom to the hole. Spin move good.
And
what a pass by Wendell Green.
Yeah, he's showing off a little bit in the passing game today.
Eight assists now. Make that eight. Yeah. Eight assists for Wendell Green. 16:56 second half. Auburn up by 21 points. South Carolina basketball. Into the corner, Brown, right side. Picked up by Broom there. Drives on Janai. Into the lane. Spins, gets double teamed. Backdoor pass kicked out of there. Here's Auburn the other way. Green whips a pass, Flanagan into the hole for the dunk. What a pass by Wendell Green at midcourt. 9 assists for Wendell. 16:28 second half. Auburn by 23 in Columbia. Gigi Jackson against Johan Traor. Out to the top for Brown and a three. It's no good. Rebound Janai Broom for the Tigers. Janai, 19 points, 6 rebounds on the afternoon. Wendell at the top spins and gets fouled by Jacoby Wright. Yeah, Wendell is feeling it as your point guard here today for the Auburn Tigers, friends.
Yeah, and some of these passes are not your run-of-the-mill assists either.
Well,
there's
that
some
pass
no
to
look.
Flanagan before, he delayed to make it and then threw the bullet pass.
Yeah.
Broom is out, and Cardwell is in for Auburn. Flanagan at the left wing off the inbound. To Wendell, left side of the key. Wendell working on right. Gets the screen he wants. Picks it up down the lane. Wendell bumped, leans in, out of there, and it comes out of there to South Carolina. He got pinned a little bit. Carolina ball, Johnson, left wing three. No, rebound to Gigi Jackson. Kicks it back to Johnson. Out to the top, it's Carter for three, no good. And the rebound to Allen Flanagan for the Tigers. Auburn by 23 points, Tiger basketball. Zepp Jasper in the front of the Auburn bench gets the ball to Wendell Green, top of the circle. Left wing Flanagan. Allen head fake, drives into the lane. Underneath, gets it back out to the top. Third shot clock at 12 for Wendell Green. With a screen from Cardwell. To Cardwell. Dylan, left side. Three ball, Johan. Good from the left wing.
Fifth three ball of the year for Johan Traor. Second of the game. Patience for Auburn with the big lead. They can afford to be more patient, look for the best shot in an offensive set.
Auburn 51, South Carolina 25, Carolina ball. Jackson working on Traor. Step back three, got it. Two of the top freshmen in the country going at each other right now. 51-28 Auburn.
Jackson gives the Hulk Hogan cup the ear to the Auburn bench with his team down 23.
Okay. On the right side, Wendell. 18-footer in the air, didn't get it, and the rebound pulled in by Michi Johnson for South Carolina. Johnson, long three, short, rebound Flanagan for Auburn. Outlet, Wendell, on the break for the Tigers. Free throw line, left side of the lane. Hands the ball to Cardwell at the lane. Gives the ball right back to Wendell from 17. Bang! 53-28 Auburn, 14-10 to go in the second half in Columbia. Michi Johnson penetrates, tried to get it into the corner, and it was knocked out of his hand out of bounds, and a timeout. 14-06, Auburn closed the first half hitting its last six shots. They've opened the second half hitting four of their first five. Auburn 53, South Carolina 28, as Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
This is the moment you've been waiting for.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our home.
When you step onto the court and into the spotlight, the moment to show that hard work and long days pay off. Because when that final shot leaves your hands and we leave our seats, that powerful moment connects us all.
Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Power for a better Alabama.
I'm getting vaccinated with Prevnar 20.
So am I, because I'm at risk for pneumococcal pneumonia.
I'm asking about Prevnar 20 because there's a chance pneumococcal pneumonia could put me in the hospital. Age 65 or older, you may be at increased risk for pneumococcal pneumonia. Ask your doctor or pharmacist about getting vaccinated with Prevnar 20, pneumococcal 20-valent conjugate vaccine, a Pfizer vaccine that can help protect against pneumococcal pneumonia in just one dose. Prevnar 20 is approved for adults to help prevent infections from 20 strains of the bacteria that cause pneumococcal pneumonia. Continued approval may depend on a supportive study. Don't get Prevnar 20 if you've had a severe allergic reaction to the vaccine or its ingredients. Adults with weakened immune systems may have a lower response to the vaccine. The most commonly reported side effect was pain at the injection site. For additional common side effects and full prescribing information, please call 1-855-213-2138 or visit Prevnar20.com.
I want to be able to keep my plans.
So I'm asking my doctor about getting vaccinated with Prevnar 20.
A look at the defensive statistics is brought to you by Cook's Pest Control and Centricon. You don't have to live with termites.
Auburn 53, South Carolina 28. Really, the one stat that counts the most. I mean, South Carolina has beaten Clemson and Kentucky this year when they've shot the three ball well. Today, Brad, they're 3 of 21 from the field, and Auburn leads 53-28.
And because Auburn has built a big lead, they feel pressured to take more threes. 21 of the 39 shots have come from beyond that arc. Auburn is allowing just 25% from there, and if this kind of clip keeps up, that number is going to go down. The three-point defense has been really good for the Tigers.
No one gets you closer to college basketball than SiriusXM. Download the SiriusXM app. Take your Auburn Tigers with you all season long. Tune in to SiriusXM SEC Radio for news, talk, analysis, and more. Straight from your phone, no car required.
Auburn, if you look at team numbers, big advantages in a lot of places. Points in the paint. 30-12 for the Tigers. Auburn has forced 9 turnovers, and they're leading in points off turnovers 14-1. One being a free throw obviously means South Carolina hasn't been able to turn any Auburn turnovers into a transition bucket. And speaking of transition, fast break points 14-2 in favor of Auburn. So they're speeding South Carolina up. They're turning South Carolina over. They're winning in the paint. And that's why the scoreboard also shows this level of control that Auburn's had today.
Trey Donaldson, Katie Johnson, Alan Flanagan, Dylan Cardwell, and Johan Treor, who has a couple threes out there for the Tigers right now. Tigers up by a score of 53-28 at the Colonial Life Arena in Columbia. Carolina ball coming out of the timeout break, 23 to shoot. They lob it inbounds, and it's knocked out of bounds by Dylan Cardwell. They were trying to feed Josh Gray down the left sideline.
They were flirting with a five-second call, too.
Jacoby Wright will trigger again. Inbound to Gregory Gigi Jackson II. Gets the ball back to Jacoby Wright. Between the circles, picked up by KD. Backs up, drives out to the right sideline, picks it up. Jackson has it inside the arc against Trey Donaldson. Backs him down a little bit, goes up and draws the foul on Trey.
Pretty savvy play. You're starting to see a little of that here and there. Trey's hands are reaching a little too far in. Then Jackson does a sweep down with the ball, and that forces the contact. It's an easy whistle.
He'll be back at the free throw line. Jackson on the day, 5 of 15 from the field, 2 of 4 from the line. First free throw from Gigi Jackson. It is good. Auburn basketball brought to you by Auburn Opelika Tourism. Start your next visit to the Plains at aotourism.com. 53-29 Auburn, 13:47 to go in the second half. And the free throw good as well. Jackson has all the scoring for South Carolina in the second half. 13:41 on a counting clock in the second. Tigers up 53-30. Flanagan down the left side of the lane. against Jackson. Into the corner, Alan Preach. No good. And the rebound pulled in by Jacoby Wright. Up the floor to the right wing for Jackson. Back to Wright. Down the lane. Ball batted around. Here's Auburn the other way. Flanagan ahead. Johan Traor. One dribble. Double hand hammer. That had to feel good. 55-30. Auburn on top. 13-14 in the second half. Fast break points right now. 16-2 for Auburn. Jackson, turnaround, baseline left, good.
He's going to be a great player.
Yes, he is.
Going to be a really good player for Carolina.
Right wing Flanagan, or maybe the NBA.
Yeah.
At the top, it's Traor. Johan, a bounce pass to Flanagan. Inside the arc to Traor, left wing. Three ball, Johan short. Little bit low trajectory there, and Jackson clears the rebound. Up the right side for Chico Carter. Jackson at the top, drives on Flanagan, bumps him, Euro step to the hole, good. Carolina on a 4-0 run, 55-34 Auburn, 12:30 to go in the second half. Donaldson, they go to a little bit of a zone, KD to Donaldson, right side of the circle, inside the arc. KD out on top, corner, Traor, three, nope, weak side rebound Flanagan. Allen, one dribble in the lane, lost it. Gets the ball to Cardwell. Dillon back to the wing for KD Johnson. Penetrates. Bounce pass underneath intended for Traor. It was kicked. And Auburn will get additional shot clock as here comes Lior Berman in replacing Allen Flanagan. Allen has 4 points, 10 rebounds though,
yeah,
for Allen Flanagan.
Well, he had, what, 7 rebounds in the first half
and his
at
career,
LSU?
His career high is 10 this year against St. Louis.
No.
So Allen has tied a career high with 10 boards here today. Auburn ball out of bounds. 20 to shoot. Inbound to Donaldson. Top of the circle, Johan. Into the lane. Left wing, Donaldson, three. Didn't get it. Weak side rebound,
foul
Berman. And Berman gets thrown down, and it's a jump ball. Berman got thrown to the floor by Brown. That should have been his fourth foul. They call it a jump ball, and Carolina has the arrow. Auburn 55, South Carolina 34, 11:57 to go in the second half, and this is the Auburn Sports Network.
Get your game day started with the CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off on the Auburn Sports Network. 30 minutes before each Auburn basketball game, get a breakdown of the matchups, player profiles, a 60-second scout of the opponent, SEC report, and our exclusive pregame interview with head coach Bruce Pearl. CBNS Bank has been family, community, and financially strong since 1906. The CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off, only on the Auburn Sports Network.
Kaneka Sausage is a product we all know and love, and it's the official sausage and hot dog of the Auburn Tigers. Kaneka Sausage is made from the finest cuts of pork, patented blend of seasonings, all natural casings, and smoked over a pure hickory fire for that true southern flavor. Enjoy a crowd-pleasing Kaneka Sausage dog or premium hot dog while watching the Tigers, and make Kaneka part of your game day or any day. Kaneka Sausage is celebrating their 75th year of the Sessions family, making their premium smoked sausage in Evergreen, Alabama. Be sure to visit the new Kaneka gift shop right off I-65 at exit 96.
In 1925, Modelo began brewing beer for those who believe in better. A model beer, steeped in the tradition of tireless effort. A rich, Pilsner-style lager for those who wear their heart and heritage on their rolled-up sleeve. Since our first batch to every bottle raised today, we've proved that it doesn't matter where you come from. It matters what you're made of. Modelo Especial, brewed for those with a fighting spirit. Drink responsibly. Beer imported by Crown Imports, Chicago, Illinois.
Back in our Auburn Sports Network studios, Jacob Hillman here with a check of the Yellowwood scoreboard. Kentucky able to get it done against Texas A&M 76-67. Texas A&M comes to Neville Arena on Wednesday at 8 Central. Auburn Sports Network coverage begins at 7:30. Number 9, Tennessee, leading LSU 34-20 with a minute and a half to go in the first half. And in top 25 action, number 11, Arizona defeats number 5, UCLA 58-52. And number 14, TCU, dominates number 2, Kansas, 83-60 at Allen Fieldhouse. Now back to Colonial Life Arena with the voice of the Tigers, Andy Burcham and Brad Law.
Auburn leads by 22 points with 11:57 to go in the second half. And right now for Carolina, Brad, it has turned into the G.G. Jackson show.
G.G. Jackson has 20 of their 34 points. He has 17 of their 41 shot attempts, and he has 7 of their 12 makes on the afternoon. Without him, they'd be lost. Now, you can see he's going to rein in the shot selection a little bit as he grows and as he matures as a player, but he's got really fluid moves. He's got a smooth shot falling away or going toward the basket. Just an impressive player.
They're going to have to look elsewhere. He's getting a rest right now.
Yeah.
Carolina basketball, Auburn by 22. South Carolina ball as Johnson, Michi Johnson, works across midcourt. Bounce pass to Brown, top of the key. Crossover dribble to the right hand, dribbles off the right side, backdoor pass. Nobody there except the photographers at the baseline, and Auburn gets it. That will be turnover number 12 against South Carolina. And Auburn has outscored Carolina off turnovers today, 16-1.
There was one back cut by Johnson. Brown thought that Carter was going to back cut to follow him, and he didn't. He faked it, but then didn't go.
Williams loses the ball on the right wing, and the ball goes out of bounds. Jalen had the ball. I think he was looking for Lee or Berman on the opposite side. Carolina ball. 11.5 to go in the second half. Auburn leads by 22 points. Brown top of the circle. Transfer from the Citadel to Carter. Drives to the free throw line. Picks up the dribble. Off the right wing for Michi Johnson. Johnson drives on Berman down to the baseline. Reverse layup. He didn't get it, but there's a whistle and a foul.
Johnson is just 1 of 7 from the floor. Auburn has done a really good job defensively. 6 of his 7 attempts have come from three. They've not allowed him often to drive to the right side using his right hand. However, his 2 free throw attempts earlier and his 1 field goal make came on such plays.
He is their best free throw shooter, and he makes the first. The sophomore transfer from Ohio State, averaging just a touch under 16 points per game in SEC play. That was a foul, by the way, against Berman as Johnson makes both free throws. And Auburn's lead is trimmed to 19, 55-36. KD Johnson at the right wing, lobs it into the corner for Berman. Lior brings it out to the pass underneath. Donaldson to Broom, kicks into the corner. Head fake and a drive by KD, who was fouled on the play by Johnson. It'll be the second foul on Michi. KD was looking for the continuation call, but Auburn will have it out of bounds.
Yeah. Maybe he goes ahead and shoots it that first time. Yeah. He might have gotten it.
Berman the inbound near midcourt. Donaldson, right wing KD Johnson. Inside the arc, back door to Berman. Out to the top for Trey down the left side of the lane. Reverses back out, picks up the dribble. Needs to get rid of it, does to KD Johnson straight away. Into the lane, Broom up from 5. It didn't go. Rebound, Jalen back up, missed it. Rebound to Carolina with the ball. Carter up the floor for the Gamecocks. Lobs it underneath for Gray. A strip by Johnson and a call against KD. First foul on KD. That's going to bring Wendell Green Jr. in, replacing Trey Donaldson at the point. What has Wendell done, you ask, today? Wendell Green Jr., Auburn's starting point guard on the afternoon, has 9 points, a rebound, and 9 assists. Gray at the free throw line makes the first for Carolina. He's a 47% free throw shooter.
So then history would say he should miss the second one, right?
That's what history says.
Yeah.
Green, Johnson, Berman, Broom, Jalen for Auburn. Gray makes both free throws.
We'll miss two next time.
And it's a 17-point Auburn lead, 55-38 with 10:31 in the second. This is an 8-0 run, the best of the day for South Carolina. Wendell Green to the right wing. Maintains the dribble, picks it up now. Lobs it out near midcourt for Jalen. Back to Wendell. Down the right side of the lane. To Jalen to the basket and a whistle and a foul. There's some understanding of that offense, isn't there?
Yes, there really is. And, you know, Jalen's versatility to be able to play and run the point part of the offense, not point guard, but at the point, the top of the key between the circles, and then to flash down the lane and Wendell know where he's going to be. This team knows each other well, and they know the totality of the offense well.
Free throw is missed by Jalen. Auburn's gone 3 minutes and 5 seconds without scoring. And the Tigers' lead has been trimmed to 17. As high as 26. And Jalen knocks home the second free throw. 12 points on the afternoon for Jalen Williams. 56-38 Auburn. 10-12 in the second half, South Carolina ball. Johnson, Michi, inside the arc, back out, working against KD Johnson. Picks up the dribble. Now to Brown outside the arc, right wing. Drives on Jalen. Backs him into the lane. Fade away, foul. And Brown will go to the line for two.
Came on the help. KD came over and tried to help, but he didn't have the angle to help. He just slapped at the arm.
Second foul on KD Johnson. And Hayden Brown is at the line for two. Free throw is up and it's good. His 30 career high 37 points, I'm sure, blazing in the memory of Lamont Paris, because it came while Brown was at the Citadel against Chattanooga.
Oh.
He makes both free throws.
Can I pay homage to Coach Smith here?
Yeah.
We don't want to give these people a chance to score with the clock dead.
Sonny would be proud of you right now.
Thank you.
56-40 Auburn. They've cut Auburn's lead down from 26-16. Wendell penetrates a double team, picks it up, gets it to Jalen. Right wing for Wendell for three. Missed it long, rebound weak side to Janai, puts it up and in.
Love that Janai kept the ball high when he came back down. He didn't let it go below his chin. Got it high, put it back up high.
21 points and 8 rebounds for Janai Broome. Auburn up 58-40. Johnson between the rings for Carolina. Right wing for Brown for three. Got it.
He's known more as a driver than an actual three-point shooter, and now they are 4-for-22 from
58,
three.
58-43, Carolina, trailing Auburn. They've gone to a zone. Wendell Green penetrates that zone to the right wing for Williams, into the corner for Berman. Lior for three, in and out. Rebound Gray for Carolina. Auburn's lead is 15, Carolina ball, 8:45 in the second. Drive by Johnson, gives to Gray for the dunk. His first field goal of the day. The lead is trimmed to 13. And the Carolina fans kind of getting back into it. Wendell across midcourt. Timeout Auburn. 8:28 to go in the second. South Carolina has cut Auburn's lead to 13 points. Auburn 58. South Carolina 45 as Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
Hey, I'm Charles Barkley. Call for a Redmont and water at bars and restaurants throughout the great state of Alabama. Redmont Vodka, available at select ABC stores and package stores. Redmont Vodka is 8 times distilled, gluten-free, and is made from non-GMO corn. Looking to support a local business? Redmont Distilling is Alabama proud and minority-owned. Learn more online at redmontdistilling.com.
What widens the eyes, tightens the stomach, and flutters the heart. Adrenaline. Feel it for yourself in the Toyota RAV4, Camry, Corolla, and Tacoma. Get 2.9% APR for 36 months on a new 2023 Toyota RAV4. Toyota, let's go places. Offer valid through January 31st, 2023. Zero down for well-qualified buyers with approved credit and financing through Southeast Toyota Finance. $29.04 monthly payment for every $1,000 finance. Excludes tax, tag, registration, title, and duty fee. See dealer for details.
Do you want to know the secret to making a Whataburger? The secret is, there is no secret. It's simple. We make every Whataburger hot, fresh, and made to order with our never-frozen 100% American beef patties, crisp, juicy veggies, fresh toasted buns, and most importantly, we don't start cooking until after you order. Now, if you want to know an actual secret, I put grilled jalapenos on my Whataburger. Whataburger, just like you like it.
Keep it here after the game for the Regions Bank postgame show with final stats and analysis, plus comments from Coach Pearl. Now back to the game.
26-point lead for Auburn has been cut in half with 8:28 to go in the second half. Auburn on top 58-45. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification on the Auburn Sports Network. Great action in and around the Auburn campus tomorrow. Auburn women's tennis will host North Carolina, the number one team in the country, tomorrow at noon at the Yarbrough Tennis Center, and then Samford tomorrow afternoon at 4. In the meantime, Auburn women's basketball is at home against Ole Miss tomorrow at 4. Britt Bowen, Dr. Larry DeShere with the call on FM Talk 93.9 in the Auburn area. The Auburn Tiger app. Pre-game programming begins tomorrow afternoon at 3:45. South Carolina has hit its last 4 shots. On the other hand, Auburn has only made 1 of its last 8. For Auburn, Janai Broom, Jalen Williams, Allen Flanagan, Katie Johnson, and Wendell Green on the floor for the Tigers. Gray comes out for Carolina. They go underneath with Bozeman Verdonk. Underneath, Broom up for a shot, and he draws the 4th foul on Hayden Brown. It was on the floor, so Auburn will have it out of bounds baseline left.
Janai is trying to argue that he was shooting. He was closer to the baseline than he was a shooting angle on the post, and it looked like he was trying to throw the ball out on the wing.
One of the impressive parts about this run by Carolina, they did a lot of this without G.G. Jackson on the floor. Auburn ball at the top. It's Broom. Janai, bounce pass to the hole, head fake by Jalen. Up for the shot. No.
How was that?
How was that not basket interference? GG three, good, it's a 10-point game.
Well, that's a big 5-point swing.
Sure enough is. 10-point game with 8 minutes to go. Wow. Wendell lobs it into the corner for Flanagan, double team. Passes out along the sideline for Wendell. Out to the top for KD Johnson. KD, baseline left for Jalen. Left wing head fake KD. At the top, it's Wendell. Into the right corner for Flanagan, goes baseline. Into the left corner, left wing KD, 19-footer, no good. Rebound Jalen in a crowd, he lost it, and a foul is called.
Oh,
they called that foul on Michi Johnson, it's his 3rd. And we've got a media timeout. 7:29 to go in the second half. What was once a 26-point lead for Auburn has been trimmed to 10. Auburn 58, South Carolina 48. This is the Auburn Sports Network.
Download the Auburn Game Day app. Find tickets, skip concession lines, be a part of game day giveaways. Shop the latest Auburn gear. Stay current with a comprehensive social media stream. Participate in game day light shows. Plus, listen to every Auburn Sports Network broadcast, even when multiple games are happening simultaneously. On the official mobile app of Auburn Athletics, the Auburn Game Day app. Get it today.
Most creatures blend in with their natural surroundings. However, one North American beaver colony is doing anything but. This group, having discovered new Yellowwood Protector semi-transparent stain and water repellent, has coated their lodge in a lovely smoky gray color. Modern look and powerful protection, backed by the yellow tag. Well done.
Introducing the first stain worthy of the yellow tag. Yellowwood Protector semi-transparent stain and water repellent. Find a dealer near you.
And we're back with breaking news. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever.
That's right, Jim. Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for any Coke fan, so make sure you... Jim. Jim. We're on the air.
Ooh, yes, this tastes like the best Coke ever to me. Your thoughts, Jen?
Well, can I have a sip?
Jen, we're in the middle of reporting the news.
I need to try it first.
Jacob Hillman back in our Auburn Sports Network studios with a check of the Yellowwood scoreboard. A few games at halftime in the top 25, including number 9 Tennessee leading LSU 39-22. Number 20 Marquette leads Seton Hall 37-29. And number 21 Baylor is trailing Oklahoma 30-26. All 3 of those games at halftime. We'll have a full check of the Yellowwood scoreboard during the Regions Bank postgame show after Auburn and South Carolina get done. We'll go back to Columbia with Andy Burcham and Brad Law.
Auburn 58, South Carolina 48 with 7:29 to go in the second half. How has it happened? Well, Carolina's gone on an 8-0 run. They've outscored Auburn 18-3 in the last 5:38. They have made their last 5 field goals. Auburn has made only 1 of its last 10, and Auburn has gone 2 minutes and 4 seconds without scoring. Auburn ball out of bounds, baseline right, leading by 10.
Andy, I'm looking over at the bench. Zepp Jasper has a wrap around his knee.
Yeah, right knee.
And a lot of this has happened after Zepp came out of the game. He's played 16 minutes. And so, yeah, he just took it off, kind of rewrapped the wrap around his right knee over on the Auburn bench. And that's a big part of this. He's kind of the tone setter defensively for the Tigers.
Inbound Flanagan to Green. Lobs it at the top for Jalen. Shot clock at 16. Left wing KD Johnson. Bounce pass out to the top for Wendell Green. 10 to shoot for Auburn. Auburn's lead is 10. Wendell lobs it. Weak side. Flanagan lost it and was fouled as he went up for an alley-oop. I don't know if that's going to be a shooting foul, but Auburn will be at the line, and it is not a shooting foul. It's a 1-1. So Auburn is in the bonus for the remainder of the game. The next foul, and Carolina will be in the bonus as well. Foul goes against Benjamin Bozeman Verdonk. All right, Allen at the line to shoot two, or a one in bonus. And the first is good. Flanagan with 5 points. Second half presented by Wind Creek Hotel and Casino with three Alabama locations in Atmore, Montgomery, and Wetumpka. You escape every day at Wind Creek Hotel and Casino and online at windcreek.com. Flanagan makes both free throws. Auburn's lead is 12. 7-10 on a counting clock in the second. Michi Johnson across midcourt. Davis at the top for Carter. Working on Wendell Green. Top of the circle for Donk. To the right wing. Davis outside the arc, 9 to shoot. Into the corner for Verdonk. Drives on Broom. Loses the ball. It's taken away by Wendell Green. Here's Auburn 4-on-2. Wendell down the lane. Flanagan glides to the hole and scores.
Green's awareness of where Flanagan is on the floor and vice versa has been something to watch here this afternoon.
His 10th assist of the afternoon, and the Tigers lead by 12, and there's a steal by Wendell. He'll drive to the hole, and he has a double-double. Wendell Green, 10 points, 10 assists. And Auburn goes up by 16 points, 64-48 with 6:15 in the second half. Johnson to the hole, put it up, no, but he was fouled by Green. Or was it Green or was it KD? It was against KD. That's his third.
Auburn on average this year is getting about 6 fewer free throw attempts than the opponent in SEC play. LSU shot exactly 6 more than Auburn did Wednesday night in Baton Rouge. Tonight, it's a +5. It'll be +7 advantage.
Free throw is good for Johnson. Jasper checks back into the Auburn lineup without the wrap on his right knee, replacing KD Johnson. Gray is back into the game on the low post for Carolina, replacing Benjamin Bozeman's Verdonk. And the second free throw good as well by Michi Johnson. 64-40, Auburn, 6:12 remaining in the second half. Wendell Green Jr. aired early. He has 11 points and 10 rebounds. Jalen. Left wing, inside the arc, free throw line, Broom from 13, good.
They had to respect Allen Flanagan's potential flash along the right baseline, so they played back a little bit on Broom. That's a practice shot for Janai.
66-50, Auburn on top, 5:48 in the second half. Gigi Jackson, a bounce pass at the top, almost picked up by Wendell, down the lane, drive to the hole, hit the bottom of the rim, rebound out of there to Broom. Outlet, Flanagan spins across midcourt. Loses the ball, gets it back to Wendell. Head fake at three, penetrates. Head fake again in the lane, out to the top for Flanagan. 19 to shoot for Auburn. Allen backs it up. Tigers by 16. Flanagan drives on Gray. Bass Gray to the hole. He didn't get it. And the rebound to Michi Johnson for Carolina. Up the floor, Carter. Down to the baseline. Out to the top. Three ball, Johnson. No. Rebound, Broom for Auburn. Just pulled it down with that left hand.
That's 9 rebounds now for Janai.
23-8 today. Or excuse me, 23-9 today for Janai. 66-50, Auburn on top. 4:52 in the second half. Wendell inside the arc, left wing. Backs it up against the Carolina zone. Free throw line, Broom from 15, switch.
If Gray is going to play back on Broom, he'll hit 30 before this game's over.
his career high 32 when he was at Morehead State against Murray State. 68-50, Tigers on top. Jackson picks up the dribble down the low post. Gray against Broom. Goes to the hole. He didn't get it. Rebound, Janai. There's a double-double for Janai Broom. His sixth in his, or his fifth in his last seven games. Alley-oop, and Broom throws it home from Wendell Green Jr. You hear the Auburn crowd.
Andy, I'd say South Carolina's momentum streak has been snapped.
Well, it's a 6-0 run by Auburn right now. The Tigers are back up by 20 with 4 minutes to go in the second half. At the top, Jackson, GG, 17-footer, good. Woo. That's a career high for GG Jackson and a timeout called by South Carolina. 3:53 to go in the second half. Auburn has made five of his last six, has taken what was a 10-point lead up to 18. Auburn 70, South Carolina 52. Auburn basketball continues on the momentum.
And we're back with breaking news. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever.
That's right, Jim. Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for any Coke fan, so make sure you... Jim. Jim. We're on the air.
Ooh, yes, this tastes like the best Coke ever to me. Your thoughts, Jen?
Well, can I have a sip?
Jen, we're in the middle of reporting the news.
I need to try it first.
The passion, the tradition, the rivalries. SiriusXM is your destination for all things college sports, and we've got your school covered. On SEC Radio, there's complete coverage of every school in the conference, including live games, plus 24/7 talk and analysis. So cheer along online or on the SiriusXM app and listen to your favorite team anywhere. And now, as a college student, you can stream your first 3 months of SiriusXM for $1. Fees and taxes apply. See offer details and subscribe now at SiriusXM.com/SEC Sports.
By now, your daily routine is probably a little too routine. Don't you want to change? Don't you want to start playing by your own rules and escape the routine so your fantasy becomes reality? Where every night is an adventure, where new flavors are ready to be tasted, where it feels like you're a winner. Take a chance. Reward yourself. Make your routine anything but routine. Escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
Follow us on Twitter and Instagram at AU Sports Network.
Now back to more Auburn basketball.
Auburn 70, South Carolina 52 with 3:53 to go in the second half. Double doubles today for Janai Broom with 27 points and 10 rebounds. And Wendell Green Jr., 11 points and 12 assists. His 12 assists, three under his career high. He had 15, setting an Auburn school record against Tennessee Tech. That's not an Auburn school record. It's his career high against Tennessee Tech last year.
Yeah.
All right, when's the last time Auburn had two players with double-doubles in a game?
I know the answer, so.
Did you know the answer before?
I didn't before. No, right. I was looking it up during the break.
The last time Auburn had two double-doubles in the same game, Jabari Smith, who was at 20 points and 14 rebounds, and Walker Kessler, 13 points, 10 rebounds, first round of the NCAA tournament against Jacksonville State back on March 18th of last year. So Gamecocks,
yeah,
to Gamecocks.
Right. I remember that game well.
I do too. I remember talking into a phone in the second half of that game. And you did fine play-by-play from the studio.
From the studio. I don't know about fine.
It was very good.
Yeah.
Auburn by 18, Tiger ball, 3:51 in the second half. Let's go Auburn chant comes up from the orange and blue here. Wendell double team, bounce pass to Williams to the right wing for Flanagan. Shot clock at 15. Allen leads to Broom. He lost it. It comes into the corner for Jasper. Now Jalen to Wendell. 9 to shoot. Wendell between the circles gets a screen from Broom. Penetrates. Outside the arc, 4 to shoot, 3 to shoot. Wendell penetrates, lobs it up there off the glass. He didn't catch iron. And South Carolina will get the ball back with 3:22 to go in the second half.
Took 30 seconds off the clock, though. As long as Wendell's all right, took a hard fall to the deck.
Auburn back in action on Wednesday night against Texas A&M. That's an 8 o'clock start. What a great crowd we're going to have for that one. We'll be on the air at 7:30 from Neville Arena. underneath Brown against Jalen, up for the shot, missed it. Jalen called for the foul.
I'm not sure what Jalen did there, what else he's supposed to do differently.
And Bruce Pearl and the Auburn staff agrees.
Yeah, his hands went straight up. They never came forward. So
Hayden Brown at the line for two. Free throw by Brown. It's good. Auburn led by as much as 26 points in this game. That came with 15-16 to go in the second half. Carolina cut it to as close as 10. 3:08 in the second half, and Carolina cuts the lead to 16. Hayden Brown's had a good second half.
Yeah.
Foul trouble in the first half. Auburn 70-54. Brent Green drives against Johnson to the hole. Got it and got fouled on the play. Wendell Green Jr. split a double team, reverse layup to the hole, and the and one.
He's the ringleader. He just got out there. That, I mean, we've seen some circus passes and some circus shots today, and Wendell Green Jr. has been the ringleader.
13-12, 13 points, 12 assists for Wendell Green Jr.
But the only thing he did wrong was miss a free throw earlier.
Goodness gracious, snapped his consecutive streak at 25. And he starts another one. 73-54 Auburn, 2:58 to go in the second half of play. Carolina ball, almost turned it over. G.G. Jackson at the point. He's gone for a career-high 25 today. Chico Carter penetrates against Zepp, puts it up from 15 and scores. Chico 73-56 Auburn, 2:34 in the second half of play. Wendell Green Jr. across midcourt. Time is on Auburn's side right now, friends. Wendell leaves for Zepp, centers it. Throws it right wing for Wendell Green. Bounce pass, Broom to the hole with the left hand. He missed it. He had Flanagan coming down the baseline. Didn't get it there. Carolina ball. And into the corner, Chico Carter. Three ball, short. Rebound, Wendell Green. Why not? Wendell up the floor, and he's fouled by Chico.
Yeah, he just needs about eight more rebounds for a triple-double.
2 minutes and 6 seconds to go. I was thinking about it. I'm with you. It'd have to happen in a hurry.
Yes, it would.
It's been a pretty darn good day for Wendell Green Jr. Junior from Detroit, Michigan, Eastern Kentucky. Second team preseason All-SEC. Free throw, he missed it. That's odd.
Yeah.
To see him miss two in a game. Brown up the floor for Carolina. Auburn up 73-56. Long three. It's good from Michi Johnson. Auburn by 14, a minute 50 to go in the second half. Carolina, 6 of 26 from the three-point stripe today. Wendell centers it between the circles, drifts off the right side, gets the ball to Broom, left wing Jasper. To Wendell with a screen from Boone. Backs up, but a double team. Whips a pass underneath for Broom, and it was deflected out of bounds by Gray. Auburn ball, 8 to shoot, a minute 31 to go.
When a big guy is retreating back into the post after defending outside the lane, they're taught just throw your hands up. Run to the post with your hands up. Gray did that and deflected off.
Jalen will trigger baseline left into the corner for Wendell Green Jr. for a three. It's in and out. Gray gets the rebound for South Carolina. 73-59 Auburn, a minute 22 to go. Michi Johnson at the right wing. Drives, gets it underneath for Gray. Gray to the hole, puts it in. Carolina calls a timeout. Auburn's lead is trimmed to 73-61 with a minute 14 to go in the second half of play. Carolina has actually outscored Auburn here in the second half. 39-24, they've hit four of their last five, and Carolina on a 7-0 run right now.
They've hit four of their last five shots to get up to 36.5% for the game. They're over 52% for the second half.
Yeah, they only went, well, in the first half of play, they were 25% at 8 of 31.
And Auburn was up over 50% in that first half. They're down to 50% for the game, 30 of 60. A minute 11 to, or minute 14 to go here in this game, and South Carolina trying to mount a rally. It's not over by any stretch of the imagination. You got to think they're going to start fouling, perhaps, down 12. But if Auburn is able to hold on here and get out of Columbia with this win, it would be an impressive feat. It would mean that Auburn, as long as it doesn't trail, will have not trailed a single second in these back-to-back road games this week. And right. They will have trailed for under one total minute in the last three games.
But South Carolina ball with a minute 14 to go. Go ahead, Brad.
I say that to point out that we've talked about strong starts, and at the beginning of conference play, Auburn struggled to get out to good starts. Well, these last three, four ball games, a good start is exactly what we've seen, and the Tigers have been able to carry that throughout.
Auburn got off to a good start in both halves. Carolina has mounted its run since about the 16-minute mark of the second half.
They will press.
Auburn ball out of bounds, full length of the floor to go. Jalen Williams will trigger. And gets the ball on a bounce pass, and Zepp Jasper is quickly fouled by Chico Carter, and that's his fourth. No panic.
No.
On that inbound. They were getting close, but Auburn ran the play and got Zepp Jasper on a curl, and he's at the line for Auburn, and he's at the line. It's a double bonus. Free throw is good. Zepp on the board today.
Auburn was 5 for 8 in the first half at the line, 6 of 8 here in the second.
And he makes both to Zepp Jasper. 75-61 Auburn, a minute 10 to go second half. Carolina ball, G.G. Jackson. Outside the arc, way outside the arc on the right side. Penetrates to the free throw line. Euro step ran over an Auburn player, and they're going to call a foul on Jackson. Good call. I was afraid they were going to call it on Jalen. That's the third charge taken by Auburn today.
Yeah. Less than emphatic charge call. Like, not what you normally see on that kind of play. It confused the Carolina fans.
75-61 Auburn. And Wendell Green got an inbound pass. It was in front of the Carolina bench, and he got double teamed, pinned along the sideline, and wisely called a timeout. Lamont Paris.
All the way out.
Yeah, it comes out and greets one of the officials to talk about the call. It's the official that made the call on G.G. Jackson. Let me remind you that every Auburn three-pointer this season, Berkshire Hathaway Home Services is donating $25 to Coach Pearl's Outlive Cancer Initiative, benefiting local cancer patients and treatment centers. Auburn with 3 threes this afternoon. The damage today has been Auburn in the paint, where Auburn has outscored South Carolina 46-20, and fast break points 24-7.
And so they haven't had to settle for threes. Only 17 attempts out of 60 shots. Barely over 25% of the shots taken have had to come from three. Meanwhile, South Carolina, a team that only shoots under 32% from distance, has taken literally half of their shots from beyond the arc.
May surprise you that Auburn's best three-point shooter today, Johan Traore, with two.
So good to see, too.
Absolutely.
Last game, it was Lior Berman with 8 points off the bench. Today, Johan Traore with 8 points in 9 minutes, added a rebound to go with it.
Auburn will have about three-quarters of the court to go. Auburn will trigger in front of the Carolina bench down that sideline. Jalen Williams, Jani Broom, Wendell Green Jr., Zepp Jasper, and Alan Flanagan, Auburn starting five. Let's see who goes deep. The inbound to Wendell. He will work against Johnson. Bounce pass to Jasper. Zepp across midcourt, and he's fouled by Michi Johnson, his fourth, and Zepp goes to the line for two.
Everybody's in great shape, of course, but Zepp has played fewer minutes than
22
Wendell.
Minutes.
Yeah. Green, Williams, Flanagan, Broom have all played 30-plus today.
And you'd have had trouble convincing me of that when Auburn was up by 26 here in the second half. Green, or rather Jasper, knocks home the free throw. That gives him, he needs 61 points for 1,000 in his career. And he knocks home both. So he is 60 points away. I really hope he gets there before the end of this season. Johnson up the floor for Carolina and a long three. Didn't get it. Rebound to the floor for Jani Broome. Broome, 27 points, 11 rebounds, and Wendell is now fouled with 47.3 seconds to go. And Auburn leading by 16 points, 77-61, and some of the Carolina folks start to head out of here.
Kind of like to see Allen get two more points because...
We'd have three double-doubles today.
And I don't know the last time that happened.
Well, that's not in the notes that I saw.
No.
Wendell Green for the free throw. That is good. 15 points and 12 assists today for Wendell Green Jr. And Flanagan will sit down, so he will not get a shot at that third double-double. So does Jalen Williams. So does Jani Broome. Auburn fans to their feet as Leor Berman and Dylan Cardwell are in. Wendell Green will come out if he makes this free throw. Treyor back into the lineup for Auburn as well. Knock it home. Wendell, take a seat for the final 47 seconds. And he does.
Listen to this hand again.
Yeah. Treyor, Donaldson is in and Green comes out.
Just Auburn being Auburn.
Man, man. That's Wendell being Wendell too.
Yeah.
47.3 seconds to go. Auburn's built its lead back to 18 points. Jackson across midcourt, top of the circle. Drives on Cardwell, who grabbed him, and Jackson will go to the line for two. Jackson is a good player. Boy, he is a fine offensive player for South Carolina. The question is he here next year?
It's a great question.
Is he in the NBA next year?
The NBA doesn't mind if you're a little bit raw and underdeveloped.
Yeah, his free throw is good.
You've got the skill set.
Is he here? He will be looked at very hard by the NBA. You know Carolina wants him back for a sophomore season. Mm-hmm. As Lamont Paris tries to build this program back. Free throw, Jackson, good. Inbound Cardwell from Treyor.
Oh.
Dylan ahead, gets the ball to Donaldson to the corner. For Berman, just take time off the clock and Berman is fouled by G.G. Johnson. 79-63 Auburn, 36 seconds to go. Coming into this week, or including this week, Auburn's number 16 AP ranking, 17th in the coaches. The 30th consecutive week for Auburn in the top 25. Auburn will, that tied an Auburn record. Berman's free throw is good, as we've done Leor. Auburn will break the school record as it will most assuredly either stay where it is or move up. And will be in its 31st consecutive week of rankings. Berman missed the second free throw. The rebound comes to Jackson. Gigi up the floor, behind the back dribble, and a long three. It's good. Auburn 88, or Auburn 80, South Carolina 66, and Donaldson is fouled by Gigi Jackson.
30 points for Jackson.
Career high for Gigi.
But only 36 for everybody else combined. And Auburn has hit 80 for the second time in SEC play.
How about that? 80 to 66 Tigers.
Came in averaging about 72 points a game.
About to get it coming up from the crowd behind the Auburn bench. Donaldson at the line for two. And he missed the free throw. Was not exactly enjoyed by the South Carolina partisans here, was it? Trey knocks home the second free throw. 24 seconds to go. Drive to the hole. Block out of bounds off the shot by Davis. The block by Dylan Cardwell.
No fouls here.
Yeah, 22.2 seconds to go. Carolina ball. Auburn up 81-66. Drive to the hole. Reverse layup. Missed by Jackson. Rebounded by Donaldson. Just get the ball across midcourt. As Trey will do. And the Tigers will dribble it away. Back-to-back road games. No problem for Auburn. Auburn improves to 16-3 overall. 6-1 in the SEC. Final score from Columbia. Auburn 81, South Carolina 66. And Auburn high 27 points today for Jani Broome. The most points for the Tigers, and you can score points too with the Chick-fil-A app. Download or open the app to place an order. Earn and redeem points with the Chick-fil-A app. War Eagle, eat more chicken. Now, this was at one time, Brad, a 26-point lead in the second half with over 15 minutes to go. Credit Carolina. They made Auburn sweat, cutting the lead to 10 at one point.
Yeah, it wasn't coasting to the finish, that's for sure. There's a little bit of let up midway through the second half. South Carolina took advantage, but then Auburn hit the accelerator again, built the lead back up to 20. Carolina made a little run again on the second half of the second half, but when you build that big a lead, you make the other team exert so much effort just to try to catch up. And Auburn's lead was enough to hold up throughout and earn a sixth conference victory.
Jani Broome, 27 points and 11 rebounds. Wendell Green, 16 points and 12 assists. It's the first time Auburn's had multiple double-doubles in a game since Jabari Smith and Walker Kessler against Jacksonville State in the first round of the NCAA tournament last March. And just for measure, Jani Broome, 12 points and 6 rebounds. Allen Flanagan, 8 points and 10 rebounds. And the Tigers win it 81-66. And Brad, you brought this up, but I will repeat it. For the second straight road game in the Southeastern Conference, Auburn does not allow the home team to lead 1 second of the game.
Auburn scored the first bucket of the game, got out to a 9-2 lead, I think, at the very beginning, and then the lead swelled from there. And you know, what that means is you're getting off to good starts. And you're getting off to good enough starts that there's not even any of the early back-and-forth seesaw-type stuff in the first 4 or 5 minutes of the game. And that enables you to play a little more downhill. It forces the other team to get sped up and maybe take shots they wouldn't ordinarily take. They're out of the game plan after the first 4 minutes of the game.
Auburn led 2-0. South Carolina tied it. Auburn led the rest of the way. The final score, Auburn 81, South Carolina 66. Stay tuned. The Regions Bank postgame show is next. And this is the Auburn Sports Network.
Hey, Tiger fans. Join Coach Johnny Harris and the Auburn women's basketball staff on the Coach Jay Show. The show airs live on